Time to go. Yeah. Welcome. Yeah. Welcome, everybody. Episode 16 of the Worst Woo. Enemies podcast. How you doing, Tristan?
I'm doing okay. How are you doing? That was really drawn out okay.
Yeah. Can we mention Blucifer? Yes.
Yes, sure, go ahead.
Let me know what Blucifer is. I'm good. I've got that fast going on. I didn't grab any liquids, so this is going to be a very dry 2 hours, I feel.
Get it. Like, I just got this coffee before.
Oh, well then let me show off my new... We're live, just starting.
Wow. He had to go get a coffee. He had to put the "We'll be back" screen up. But he also has to show his work, of course, right? Because Ellie's been doing a lot of work, designing stuff and changing the outlay, like the overlays and the look of Worst Enemies. Then I will go, and you will lose me forever. When did this become a romance movie? Because that's what it sounds like to me.
This is the level of professionality you can expect from Worst Enemies podcast.
Oh, Blucifer is a statue of a horse with huge balls in front of the Denver airport. It fell over and killed the sculptor. Wow.
Dude, that's awesome.
But we might lose Neon, though, so we have to
Oh. Neon.
Rein it in.
Neon's got to go pump more loads into his wife.
Well, I was thinking, secret agent. So, Elliot, you've never mentioned that you used to do airport security.
Oh yeah, I'm sorry. Yeah. I was concealing my seething rage.
I was gonna say it's there.
That I've been outed.
Like, I'm not even like looking at like the actual like Discord where we have our like faces. I'm looking at the stream trying to catch chat, so it's great to see you like stare deeply into the fucking camera like a few seconds after you've already mentioned it.
That's nice.
So did something happen? Was like this Denver airport thing like a constant? Because I remember like it being mentioned a little bit on my stream when we talked about culty things, but...
Here's Lucifer. That's pretty fucking metal. I think this might be the new channel logo.
Just Lucifer?
Yeah, that's pretty metal. Who thought this was a good idea? I want to meet this guy. This guy's fucking awesome. I love how it's at the end.
Well, remember, you can't meet him. He's dead.
Oh, yeah. I guess I'll meet him in hell.
I'll meet him in hell. Hey, man.
Where my dad is.
What were you thinking?
Dude, this straight up has a straight up, like, yo.
Yes, it's there, right in your face. There's even a picture of just from the...
That's awesome, dude.
Did he make the beehole and everything?
That was a weird place to put a belly button, chat.
Veiny beehole.
Oh, man, we just...
That's a veiny triumphant bastard.
Oh, my God. I only sculpt realism, man.
Wow, Mossy. Blucifer is surprisingly small.
Blucifer vandalized. Graffiti found on iconic blue horse statue. Oh, man. Dude, can I get, like, a scale model? I think there's, like, a... Oh, yeah. Oh, hell yeah.
Can I get, like, a one-to-one reproduction? And
dude,
like...
I just want the lower half for reasons. Dude, how many
I just want the lower half.
How many spit takes are you gonna do, doggy?
Hmm?
I got water.
I have a problem where, like...
I got the whole jug, too!
I got the whole jug. I got a growler. No, I have a problem where, like, if you put, like, popcorn in front of me, right, the hand-to-mouth is constant. Like, I don't stop. It's just one piece at a time.
Dude,
like,
never,
it just never stops.
You never go hand-to-mouth.
I always go hand-to-mouth.
Oh, shit. Some girls want you to go hand-to-mouth.
Gotta go hand-to-mouth.
Yeah, there's Nathan, you're VIP. You're VIP doggy. And there's another VIP if he shows up.
It's a tradition to shine the horse's balls at the George Washington.
That's pretty great, dude. At the it's not a like what about the bull on Wall Street?
Oh yeah, yeah.
You like do you kiss the balls for good luck with your all your fucking your computer numbers?
Do you kiss them from the front or from behind?
Oh, there's a okay. George Washington.
Is there
statues.
A rule?
The whole statue was that green color, but the balls were really brassed. That's great, dude.
Yeah, kiss the ball.
Why do these balls always have like lipstick rings around them? Did you wait to drink so you didn't almost
no,
spit
I did
take
not.
On me?
Nope.
Okay. Oh man.
No worries.
So how's everybody doing today? Let's just get the pleasant. Let's do the pleasantries.
Yeah, what has everybody been up to?
I hand you this pleasant tree. So I mean, and how again?
You can prune it how you like.
Senpai, how be thee?
My senpai?
Yeah, I know you already answered, but really, just how are you?
How am I?
How does that make you feel?
Well, Chris Corey's in the house.
Chris Corey, what's up? Man. So, we talked about Blucifer for a minute. And
imagine kissing the balls in winter.
Anyone else have topics? Besides the reptilian overlords at Denver...
the Denver airport is apparently...
Religion and science was brought up. Yes. You want to talk...
We can do that.
Do you want to talk about, like, the birth of Abrahamic religions? Or do you want to talk about, beta decay.
Beta decay.
I mean, well, I want to shoot the camera so bad, but it's not going to end well.
I mean, we can talk about either of those things. I don't know. I
Dark Evil Dead in the house. Hey guys, shout yourselves out because that's a hard thing to do. My fingies are tired. Shoot me. SO. Please shoot us.
Collectively?
Yes. Shoot me, daddy. Brain is not functioning without coffee.
Brain, no function.
Ride wife.
Kill wife. Think about wife.
Feel sad.
Miss wife.
Miss wife. Oh, man.
It don't matter.
I'm starting it.
None of this matters.
I'm starting
it. Don't matter. No,
Moss Lover's here. What is up, Moss Lover? Oh, man. Sometimes my brain doesn't register names until... And you gotta, you gotta pick your color, folks, because, like, I associate me people with colors now.
Like, well, that happened to me yesterday.
Like, neon's always this like the same green that I am. Chris Corey's red. You're red. Moss Lover, I like that shade of green. That's good on you. Girl, that's a great shade of green. Man, I'm just vamping for 2 hours. You guys tuned into a fucking nothing burger of a show. I'm so sorry.
Well, there was already about to move closer. Are you going to strike?
Oh, no.
Are you going to take it out?
Are you one step closer to the edge?
Is that tonight's dinner? watching a bunny outside my house.
Dark. I checked out Dark Eye. It's nuts, dude. I love. I don't want to say too much and spoil it for Tristan, but I love how the like people in the game are made. I love the art. I love the medium that they've chosen.
I'm about to break.
Watching a bunny outside of my house, about to move closer.
I'm
about to break everything you say to me.
If you need a topic, I need creative ways to get someone to move their car off of our property. Ooh.
Oh, see, I'm good at making a car not move. So how do we want the car to move? Let's lean into this one. Is it just like on the yard or is it in the driveway?
How close do you live to a ravine?
Is towing an option at their expense? A ravine, I like that too.
Ravine.
Can you get the keys, pop that bitch into neutral, and just push it in the street?
What's your access to C4 looking like?
Ray, if I walked you through making a shape charge, would we get in trouble? It's really simple to make a shape charge. First, you be.
Do you have a?
Let me get a pen.
Do you have enough magnesium to burn a hole into concrete?
Do you have any old film strips? Do you have any iron filings or aluminum? I'm just gonna go through parts and
tools. Yeah.
I'm not gonna tell you how to put them together, but oh, there's like this hydrogen peroxide bomb, but it's not hydrogen peroxide. It's like hydrogen 5 oxygen.
101 ways to remove a car from your property.
They were going to show you how to make it on, like, Mythbusters. There's been a couple of shows where it's like, you can make this explosive out of household items. And they're like, we're just not going to... We can't show this on TV.
No.
Yeah. How do you make hydrogen peroxide worse? I mean, I know where to get, like, the good stuff, so... 27%, boy!
I know that, adding heat to a lot of things causes bad things, so...
I mean, toxic mustard gas! Oh, no! Yo, the janitor saved everybody. No, it didn't. It was
Joe. I was trying to actually kill everybody.
Joe Dirt, you're a hero! Joe Dirt, anybody? No. Glenn? Our
janitor. Yeah, that's what I figured you were referencing.
Well, maybe kind of vague in my mind. When we end, I'll shoot the camera. I'm just really... thinking about, like, when it, like, topples off backwards and breaks. Okay.
Don't do it, boy.
You guys, listen to the One Step Closer 100 Gex reanimation of Linkin Park. I can't stop listening to it. Well, if it wouldn't get me taken down, I'd go to it now. What are the odds?
Like, what 100 Gex, I just think, is like... Like, I'm thinking about the video game Gex...
Oh, man. I'm wondering. Wait, is this straight up Linkin Park, though?
Like, just pure Linkin Park?
Because it's what it's tagged. Hybrid Theory. Hybrid.
That was actually a pretty good album.
Well, wasn't that their original name?
I'm not sure. I don't know the...
Yeah, it was okay. Yeah, their original name was Hybrid Theory. I'm asking you to.
I see.
I'm asking you to. What is it? I'm getting Gek tattooed on my foot. Oh, that's dope. I don't know what it means, but
with that amount of C's, right?
So like... I mean, we talked about Chris Cornell dying the other. Do we want to retouch that and why?
Like, Chris Cornell times?
Chester Bennington might still be alive had they, like, been honest about Chris Cornell's suicide.
I don't know this theory.
I mean, we talked about it. Like, there's a good chance that he wasn't killing himself, but he was... A lot of ex-heroin addicts like to use their exercise bands for other purposes now.
Yeah.
Yeah. I gotta reclip this. I gotta crop this whole thing again. Oh well. So, there's this term called autoerotic asphyxiation.
Oh, yes.
So if we were honest about, like, how a lot of these celebrities die and not embarrassed about it, you probably wouldn't have a lot of repeat suicide attempts from, like, impressionable kids. I mean, you'd have a lot of kids jerking off in their closets, but, I mean, that's a simpler conversation than don't kill yourself, Timmy.
Oh, you need to clip?
BRB, no, I don't need to clip this. No, I need to recrop this scene, okay? But, which I will do right now.
And I'm glad, Mossy, that you're committing to that many C's. That's appropriate.
It's a lot of C's.
A lot of C's. That's like 6 of them.
That's a big foot, lady.
That's a big foot.
Hey, did it work? No, it didn't work. Damn it. Damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it. Just don't worry about me. I'm just gonna slowly fix the scene. Tristan Vamp.
Vamp? Okay. I don't know if Chris is still here. I don't know how long you've got, because Chris was asking me how I got my name the other day when.
Oh, you're gonna answer when he asks?
What? You asked, but I'm like, I might as well. Yes, you're here.
Jeez.
What? Gee, you're gonna answer when he asks, but not when I do?
Yeah, that's, dude. I've asked you like a dozen times, and you're just like, it's a power word. It's a killing word. So I'm a Benny Gesserit.
Yeah, it's just some
Maudeep,
man. It's just
you say your fucking
addiction. It's a curse.
You say your name in a fucking stone like. Fucking Lucifer Falls. Power words.
Yeah, I actually got it from Lucifer. I talk to him every day.
Lucifer's my dad. Hey, look, it's my dad. Lucifer. It's my dad.
At the Denver airport. He's huge.
Yo, you know there's a bunch of lizard people under there? Hey, cool.
See, what I hear... is that Lucifer protects us all.
Hey, check that out. So when you talk, there's no more green Discord box. And when I talk, people stop listening. Okay.
Oh, I thought you were going to say there was a green Discord box, but...
Oh, you need a... Oh, shit, Nathan, you fucking dirty asshole. Did you see the clip?
I'm gonna watch it. I'm just laughing as a result of you laughing because it's probably good.
I'm not playing. I'm not like Andy from Squidville would say. A lot of things can be altered on the internet. A lot of things are not true. Anyway,
I don't think that clip's gonna die, Elliot.
Nope.
I think that's just gonna. Oh, I'm sorry.
I don't take compliments well, and then stuff like that happens.
I'm glad that exists.
Oh my god, I'm gonna...
I think you showed this to me before.
Am I Twitch famous yet? Come on, guys. Hey, you think we could actually get 10 people chatting? That'd be pretty cool. And then I could stop looking at that stupid thing.
Is it stuck in your mind? Your mind space? Well, hello, person. Hello. Yeah.
Who could that be?
I am people too.
I am people too. Oh, what is this Dylan command?
Oh, the Dylan command?
I like turtles!
There we go. Who knows? Who cares?
Oh, jeez.
Did you hear it? Did you hear it?
Yes, I did. I had to listen because you said you added it, and... Hi, people. Like, look.
Hey, if you're, if I love you, eventually I'll make a fucking sound command for you, so I just gotta think of them. So, Nathan, you're probably getting a sound command. Chris, probably.
Honestly,
Neon, like, I'll think of some batshit thing to do for Neon.
I think the first thing that I heard when I went to Chris's stream was the fucking cheese command.
That's pretty awesome. What was that, like, what was that fucking long monologue from God, like, about and from? Cheese!
Oh, from Marwyn.
Maybe we'll do a cheese. We'll do, like, a shout-out to Chris Corey. I don't know what I would put there, but... It'd just be Richard Cheese.
Oh, yeah, that's a good Gouda.
Boat. Oh, my God, Richard Cheese. Last boss from Marwyn. Marwing.
Marwing, yes, it's Doofy from Marwing.
People, hey... Hairiest Crack is back. You know,
can't kill a god.
I think is that a competition? Did you win this? Do you have a medal?
This is how we're gonna get all of the achievements. Is we're gonna just be like, hey,
can we do
achievement? Hi,
can
hi.
We, can we do it? Hey, boys, we're pushing to more subs. smash that up, dude. Best in class.
Smash the button that says words and stuff.
Peephole. Yeah, just get me... Hey, guys. I need you to do me a favor. I need you to give for the goodness of our Lord and Savior, Baphomet.
Praise be unto him.
Should have said best ass. I am so sorry, man. I got caught up in other crazy shit. I didn't get any show topics. So now it's just a potpourri, you guys.
Which is like, actually, I'm liking this because me and Elliot were chatting before this.
Yeah,
but... And just, like, doing art and, like, fixing things and, like, not... We didn't really do any, like, pod prep.
Nope. All of my effort went into this sick overlay, which I'm really happy with.
Yes. I do like that your painting there kind of blends into it. I don't know if you noticed that. Like in the top, well, it's my top left corner, but I guess for you, it's like what, top right?
Oh, my painting. Yeah, this.
Yeah. See how the painting just kind of blends into it?
Yeah, it looks like a weird artifact. Like it should clip in front of me. Hell yeah. Let's talk about that for 2 hours.
Hey, let's talk about art for 2 hours.
This is going to be real fucking slow. This is going to be a long...
So Picasso was an asshole.
Yeah, dude, he paid for cigarettes with drawings. That's the rumor anyway. It's like, I don't have any money, so I'm going to doodle.
If I recall, he was really, really, really afraid of getting gonorrhea.
Oh, shit.
He had a painting. I'm trying to remember the name of it, but...
Drip Drip by Van Gogh.
Yeah, Drip Drip.
By
Van Gogh.
By Van Gogh.
Picasso.
Yep. Go on. Van Gogh on.
Van Gogh on. But he had a painting, and if you know anything about cubism, what?
Could just stop all that nonsense because we need a fucking live feed of Moss Lover's fucking front yard because a squirrel has joined the bunny.
Join the bunny!
Tristan, continue your flapping.
Continue your flapping. You tell me to do something and I do it and then I don't get any fucking respect. No. Anyways.
I'm so sorry for interrupting you. Keep going.
So, if you know anything about cubism, is a lot of times, especially in Picasso's case, he would try to show all of the angles of an object, which is part of the reason why, like, you will look at tables and, like, lemons and stuff, and you'll see parts of them that, like, would not, in terms of perspective, look that way. It's kind of like being able to perceive the entirety of an object from one angle.
Oh.
And, pretty crazy. So, he had one where there's several women... that look like they're just standing there, but it's also painted in a way where it looks like they're laying on a bed.
I see it.
Right?
Yeah, can I?
And you'll notice one of them has a green face.
Yeah, I see that too.
And that's that representation.
Is this the gonorrhea?
Potential, like, well, yeah, of like.
Oh, like one disease, in five? Right? One in five, yeah. Is a fucking. Oh, man, this. I like there's just a cornucopia. I think I could show this.
Yeah, yeah, definitely. It's just
I can't show
anyone green face.
I can't show that.
People, Denver Airport.
I can't show that. I can't show that. Neon, you got a fucking one note fiddle here, boy.
No respect.
Neon, you gotta earn that shit.
It's one thing I learned about it is that
green face.
Yes.
So like a one in five. Okay, that's a weird.
But you can see why it looks like they're standing up but also laying down, because like you can see the folds from the sheets and stuff.
Right.
And so Picasso was really afraid of catching like a disease and stuff. But if I recall, he still visited brothels. It was like kind of one of those dumb things where like,
what if,
you know, he was not true to his word.
What
of
if
course.
He, what if he was a fucking bug chaser or bug catcher instead? What oh yeah, give me those. You got open sores? Daddy like...
Okay, so the whole dark web is so insane. But
green
then
face,
you think about it.
Proof of reptilian people.
Oh, like,
God, Neon, you're asking for a timeout, bro.
Yeah, Dead's even just like, what the fuck is this reptilian people think
about? I mean, like, maybe Neon is a reptilian and he's like trying to like divert. Like, oh, no way, that's bullshit. He's like, you think the humans continue to think that?
They continue to think this.
What, we're not real.
Well, you know what? You know what, Neon? What happens if you are the reptile? What happens if you're the reptilian people? And this is you just spreading.
Did I hear Darkwood? Did you hear Darkwood?
Did I hear Darkwood?
Feeling fancy.
Oh no, I said Dark Web, but Darkwood. That's a good game.
Oh, fucking AJ! Tell us more about this B&B. Is there a squirrel and or rabbit there?
Yeah, well, are you going somewhere that we...
I like turtles.
Hell yeah. Andy's here. Andy, you gotta try the other ones, my bro. Dude, how am I not following AJ? AJ, here's a follow, boy. Jesus Christ. How did I miss you completely? Shut yourself out, dude.
Dead went for the noises command, but that's over at my channel. I think you have sounds, I think, here.
Yeah, he went for noises, yeah. But I stole that thing where Dead's like, hey, you should play that Anchorman clip. Loud noises! I got on that immediately. Sup. Oh my god. So, Andy, this one's for you, homie.
It sounds like we're all gonna have it.
That's really loud, but I love it. That's so loud. Andy, you're the best around. No one's ever gonna keep you down. And also, there's Dylan. But you know, here's how I really feel about Dylan, though. Hidden command.
Nice, Dad. I'm gonna have to stop by and check out those five best
rappers of all time.
There's a second one.
Dylan. 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 And Dylan. Why?
I spit hot fire.
That's how I really feel about Dylan.
Spit hot fire.
I made those before the show, so they're not great. That one almost deafened us.
Dreamer's in the house as well.
Dreamer.
How's it going?
Hi. Oh, man.
Trying to keep up with chat. We just exploded there.
That's awesome, though. Hey, anyone have any topics? Because I forgot. I brought everything but my topics. Andy, can we talk about the budget real quick?
Same.
Well, I just try to fix this Andy command.
You know what command we needed for this fire bit?
What's that?
That's
still too loud.
When Star Fox says fire. Well, he says hiya, but it sounds like fire.
That's better. That's a lot quieter now. My computer just crashed, so I'm watching on mobile for a bit.
Are you insane?
did you make the mistake of asking Neon for a topic? Because we're just gonna end up talking about Blucifer and Denver Airport.
Oh, there's a topic. Insurance is a giant scam.
Oh, hell yeah.
Hell yeah, it is.
I mean,
and then we just shut it down?
That's it.
Fuck yeah.
That's it. I agree with that. Two thumbs up.
Say a bunch of really logical, like, rational things at us, and we'll just agree with you.
Hey, I need a controversial opinion. I'm not gonna push...
Oh, yeah, the controversial opinion.
I'm not gonna push Jeffy's shit in over that one. Apple's bad, y'all.
Apple's bad.
Why am I struggling so hard to get to the fucking browser?
Insurance is too damn high.
Hell yeah. Dreamer, what are you up to today? Insurance is a giant scam. I'll get back
Go into every Monopoly game with an actual premise budget.
That'd be like, great. Okay, first. Well, I thought, a premise budget, not just an actual, like, not a physical. Like, not like,
no, hey. That would be crazy, though. Just be like, okay, if we don't get Boardwalk, we have to change the budget.
I just so bad want to see the fucking doodles that he was making in the fucking budget book.
Oh, wow. I actually hope that's like a burn at us, Mossy, like saying, I forgot my homework at home. That would be great. Like, it just sounds like you guys are saying you forgot your homework at home.
Pretend it's Thanksgiving, and this bread is a turkey.
Do sound commands all show.
I officially signed with an esports team Saturday. Oh, dang. Nice.
So,
congrats, AJ.
Denver Airport Conspiracies.
All right, Chris, have a good one. We appreciate you stopping by.
Thank you for stopping by, man. Conspiracy. Words are hard. Chive? What the fuck is... Denver Airport Conspiracy. Theories, rumors, and facts. You know, the fucking Denver Airport was actually built on the bones of the Stanley Hotel that The Shining was written after. I'm just making that up.
Making that up?
I don't know where the fucking Shining Hotel is. But it is the Stanley Hotel. It is the Stanley Hotel, and Stephen King slept there. And, like, he had a fucking terrible nightmare about his still-living dead daughter. Or wife? Daughter?
Daughter-wife? That's messed up.
That's a problem.
That's what we call a problem.
He knows too much about the Denver airport. Yep.
That's why Chris left.
Later, Stram. Juicy Lucy. Oh my god, it's so juicy. There's not conspiracies. Yes.
Dreamer said, I just spent 3 years paying into my insurance, had to use it for my house, and now my insurance is going up because I used it.
Oh yeah. Why is Blucifer so fucking veiny?
Well, important things.
He's got this big old fucking ribcage, like, ball sack vein.
A veiny triumphant bastard.
Okay, so how the Denver airport became an icon of the legend. Illuminati. Midway through our tour in the Denver International Airport, media relations Chief Heath... Fuck yeah, Chief Heath. Bullet points,
says,
man. The Freemasons, the Gargoyles, the Demonic Horse, this cool painting, the murals.
This cool painting.
The murals. Okay, I was a little child who longed for other worlds, but I am no more a child, for I have known fear. I have learned to hate. How tragic. Then is youth which lives with enemies, with gallows rope. Yet I still believe I only sleep today, that I'll wake up a child again and start to laugh and play. And then I can't read the bottom, but it's, yeah, clear Illuminati. Yep, you're right. This gives it away. And
what?
Some dead kid's poem or some shit.
Wow, just some dead kid's poem or
yep.
Whatever.
I mean, I am convinced. These murals, truly a sign of the Illuminati.
Is it like, is it done in MS Paint? Is it just like a total...
No, it's really beautiful.
Okay, I was gonna say, is it just like red over like actual just regular like outside colors, just crazy scrawn?
Oh yeah. Denver Airport. Okay. But like, check this shit out. This is...
Okay.
Oh yeah, it's totally just like, I see the Star of Daniel. I know it's the Star of David.
The Star of Daniel? Okay. Of Dan Dan the Mattress Man?
It's this, like, inclusive, like, anti-war...
Is it done in MS Paint like all of Squidville's streams?
Sweet. Kemp, it works sometimes.
Kemp, sometimes it works.
So here's
okay.
The poem I was reading. I just can't dig into this right now on air.
I just a Thrillist. Is this what is this site for? Like, is it just another one of those? Is it like another? Hey guys, we think this is potentially thrilling, but it's not.
So Neon, I'm sorry, I'm pushing your shit in over this, but one of us is in Illuminati. The Illuminati?
I use crayons to sign checks.
Fun fact, the hotel is actually in Glacier National Park, Montana. That's where the Stanley Hotel is. And it's Stanley, like, as in Stanley Steamer, as in, like, the Stanleys, the fucking oligarchs themselves.
I was gonna say, looking at the set and everything, it makes sense that it's in Montana.
Yo, Andy, show us your assets.
And there absolutely is nothing wrong with MS Paint.
Neon,
I could never learn how to like really use it.
Neon is the Denver airport. That's the conspiracy. Okay.
It's risky business because it is you.
I mean, there's a lot of crazy MS Paint murals. So we just that's what we're doing. We're gonna go look at MS Paint murals. Your hometown cleaner? Yes, the Stanley Steamer.
Who knows what I am? I'm an enigma.
Wrapped in a question. MS Paint.
Baked in inquiry.
Mural. Why? Like, why are 11 people watching us just bullshit?
I don't. I'm not even. I'm
oh,
paying attention.
Tristan, I found one for you.
Oh, sweet. Is it also a veiny triumphant bastard like Lucifer?
It's not MS Paint, but it's why.
It's why? I'm just waiting for it to show up. Oh, Crit here.
Crit here. Ball with it. Spin body.
No limit. Breaking that bread with my foe. Ain't even eat the whole loaf. Yeah, let's just random.
Oh shit!
Random crit appears.
Random crit. I'm okay with that. You want to just talk about?
Yes. Yes. Let's just talk about Big Crit. Do you know he's like? About Big Crit do you know he's a lyricist and he's country? I feel like that's like the weirdest.
He's lyricist and country. Like they can't be combined together.
Hey, so he's got some weird brags for sure.
Did you know that he like he's like country, but he doesn't talk about blue jeans.
Oh yeah.
He doesn't talk about red tractors.
It's green tractors, boy.
It depends. It's red pickup trucks, isn't it?
Dude, are we gonna have
red pickup trucks, green tractors?
Are we gonna have a gang war over the color of your tractor right now?
Yeah, we are.
Dude, are you the? Are you the bloods of fucking John Deere?
I'll tell you what.
These are some great.
I don't run no John Deere here.
Is there some Only Cup Cadet for you? These are some great paint murals, by the way.
Are you running Yanmar?
Oh man. I'm a Husqvarna boy myself. I was in a fucking Ace Hardware with somebody who was like, don't ever buy Husqvarna. I'm like, I never thought I was going to, but thank you.
Yeah, I would have never contemplated it, but
I mean, okay. Is it a made up word like Haagen-Dazs?
Yeah.
Blue pickups are superior. Oh, hot takes from Neon Man. Great Pacific Garbage Patch. Yeah, that's just depressing, but has anyone heard about the cleanup efforts where this dude's making this, like, it's basically like a Hoover for the garbage patch, because the whole thing spins, that's why it's, like, it's stuck there, it just kind of slowly drains into this, rotates into this, like, patch, and that's why it gets trapped there, because, like, currents are, like, all crossing, and, so he's like, if we just use this thing to, like, have garbage spin into it and catch it, we can then take this plastic and like grind it up into beads and make stuff. And that's enough by itself. Like you can't make everything out of that kind of plastic. It's like a very hard, like,
yeah,
it's really hard to make bottle plastic, like a plastic bottle. That's gotta be like raw, unrecycled. When you're getting a plastic bottle, you're just like, it says it's recycled. It's the cap. Like that's the hard bit. That's easy to make.
I was so kind he's like, of hoping
he's making sunglasses. He's making all these trinkets that you can get that will then wind up in the Pacific Ocean where he will then fish them out again.
Inevitably it'll be a cycle, but at least it won't be stuck there forever.
But he said like, yeah, there's no way you're gonna keep stuff out of the Pacific, so we just need to go get it and like make it into something and then try to keep it out.
I was kind of hoping that we would just like wait until it became an island and then fight over it like we do everything.
Oh yeah.
I was kind of hoping we would just get to that.
You're hoping that it's like it's right into the fucking Pacific Rim and that kaiju are going to fight there.
Yeah, exactly. I was hoping just Trash Island would be like the, you know, it would be the battlegrounds.
How much cooler would the garbage patch be if we're all sunglasses? That'd be fucking sweet, dude. You're the best. That one's for you, Andy.
Corey Hart left all his fucking garbage in the Pacific.
All of his fucking sunglasses.
Fucking A.
His dad left his body there. Oh, shit.
Sunglasses are inherently cool.
Yeah, I mean, that's why the fucking garbage patch would be fucking awesome. Oh, man. Can that be our banner for the show?
It's just a garbage patch of sunglasses.
Yeah, that's pretty sweet. I think that's the show title, Andy. You got it.
I left my sense of self-worth there.
Garbage, Pacific just, garbage just patch of sunglasses.
Dreamer gives us a depressing topic and then just slams it with more.
Hell yeah, dude.
How can I make this more depressing? I know. I'll put my self-worth there.
Oh man, well that's okay, it's gonna get fished out and turned into sunglasses, so that's, I mean, if my self-worth could be sunglasses, I wish I don't have sunglasses within reach, and I'm sure you don't either.
No, I definitely don't.
That would have made this way better. Oh, what I do have, hold on,
wait,
the thing is hard.
thing is hard.
There we go.
This delay. Okay. I'm just waiting for the delay.
Oh yeah, you're good.
That's all.
You're good. So
coffee break emote when? Yeah, that could be emote.
Oh right? Yeah, hell yeah. Thank you. Thank you for just giving me ideas so I don't have to think for myself. It sounds really shitty and sarcastic and mean, but I mean that. Coffee break emote. How would you get I guess it'd just be like the cool like skull on the coffee cup with some steam.
Yeah. That would probably, I mean, you only have so much room.
Yeah. Is that 28 by 28 or is that something else?
So the smallest one? I think it's the smallest one is 28 by 28.
Okay, so garbage patch. Let's look up like garbage patch cleanup.
Hey, speaking of depressing things, do we want to look at the state of the Great Barrier Reef?
Oh, yes, please do. Like, please inform us about that. Like, really, like, tragic.
Like, something even more tragic.
I love how, like, we have these, like, massive efforts and, like, all this, PR about, like, look, we're cleaning up the ocean. We're gonna plant a ring of trees around the Sahara. We're gonna make a tree wall in the Sahara. We're doing all this, like, to, like, fix the shit we fucked up. This actually looks pretty cool. Let's, the largest cleanup in history. But, like, it's all framed like, yeah, we're doing great.
I did not hear that, Dreamer.
Cookies and privacy. I'm not gonna fucking... I don't want your cookies.
Plastic bags at the bottom of Mariana's Trench.
Oh, jeez. But look at this. Look at this fucking trash conveyor. That's pretty nasty, dude.
Scallop boat. No.
Do it.
It's not a scallop boat. Do it. What? Is it like...
Do you need to know what it is?
No, like, I know what it is. I'm trying to understand the shape in a way. I'm trying to figure out the science without reading the science. I'm getting 20 to life
for killing the guy that was humping my wife. That one's just for Tristan.
That one's just for me.
I'm gonna have ridiculously long sound clips, so. Go on.
That was pretty loud.
Elliot, was that too loud?
I don't know. It might be because I'm just like listening pretty. It might be because like I'm not listening to the audio, and then when I switch over to it, it just blasts.
Oh, but, yeah. Could be. Hey, anybody.
They're a touch loud.
They're a touch loud. Oh,
my society.
That really sucks.
Andy does not have solutions, but specializes in presenting problems. Not deafening.
Fix it later. Well, I mean, the neighbor is a shooting star, so I have to drown him out.
Don't you know? I can't stand it. I can't. It's okay.
Bro,
so normally none of that stuff would bother me.
Shouldn't hear
but
your
when
stereo
there,
through my headphones.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
Somebody. Okay. So last night, somebody started bumping music at like 10:30 p.m. And you know it's a Monday, right? Which is obnoxious. And they were playing some like Luke Bryan nonsense. So it was just all like Blue Jeans and Holy and all this nonsense. That I keep saying the word nonsense. But who blasts music in an apartment complex at 10:30 p.m. on a Monday?
Inconsiderate
your neighbor,
assholes?
Your neighbor?
What is inconsiderate assholes, Alex?
And you just get up and start stomping.
You were over here, it was like 4 a.m. And he's like,
oh yeah, I remember
music
that.
Time! And so I just like started just stomping the floor.
Well, yeah, I remember that because we were just going to lay down, and you like I, and the duh duh duh.
Oh man,
not fun times.
Yeah, it's just that like I don't hate people unless they're like super disrespectful.
And that's a good example.
Yeah, he's getting in my way. He's my own worst enemy.
It's not, you don't it's get not, in your own way, just other people get in your
it's
way.
It's not me anymore. Well, that's the other part of the show. Is
That's true.
It's the part that we talk about the most, is that we get in each other's way. So, be considerate of others. Like, they're literally, like, costing you and your girlfriend sleep, which is going to affect your performance in all of your endeavors. Like, they're taking money out of your pocket, essentially. I used to have a neighbor, neighbors below me, my old apartment, that wanted to be a DJ that would be vibrating our floors at 2:30 a.m. We had to call the police like 6 times. And then they were evicted.
Jeez. Like, that's just not like a career you get into living in an apartment.
Hey, there's this thing like headphones that...
Yeah, and headphones are wonderful. You could, in fact,
you could DJ to yourself. Headphones.
I think I went so long listening to stuff in headphones that I just don't like listening to it in any other form.
You forgot what real sound is?
I feel like I've been in so many situations that it's just better to be respectful.
Can we do one of those reveals where you take your headphones off and it's like you put those colorblind glasses on for the first time and you're like, oh my.
Or I'll remove my headphones and we'll all find out I don't have ears.
Oh, man.
They're actually cat ears.
No. Jeez.
Oh, God. I'm a human with cat ears.
I do want that cat ear
emote.
There's
a cat with human ears out there.
I want that emote so bad.
What's the best?
Hey, checking the docket. What's next on the docket?
I didn't. There was. I know what's next on the docket.
That's really...
Everybody, if you're willing to share, everybody in chat, how have you been your own worst enemy recently?
Yeah.
If you're willing to share.
Unless you're Jeffy, who's never been in his way ever.
Yeah, unless you're Jeffy. Jeffy's never in his way.
Jeffy wins the gold medal. Make do. I'm just looking at the news real quick. Okay, white supremacists on par with ISIS as top threat. FBI director tells Senate. Okay, I mean, par with, so like nothing's gonna happen still.
I was gonna say when it's non-news, it's just not really news. It's just like, hey guys, did you know that this thing is the thing that it's always been?
The Cherokee Nation acknowledges that descendants of people once enslaved by the tribe should also qualify as Cherokee. That's for casino money. It's gotta be like not like, hey, you're also Cherokee, because yeah, that's 100% for that can be taken weirdly.
Yeah, that can be
100%. This was cool. The new EU right to repair law requires technology to last for a decade. New devices will also have to come with repair manuals and be made in such a way that they can be dismantled using conventional tools. So no more security bits. No more prying shit open with your fucking credit card. I wish this would come to America so bad, because here's another problem. Like, your fucking phone dies and you throw it in the garbage patch. Like, oh, we can't make billions of dollars by selling people new phones every year. Yeah, that shit's gotta stop.
Next to Corey Hart's fucking Ray-Bans.
Blue eyes, he says.
Do you think that also...
Blue eyes.
I know it takes a while to type it out, but if you're new here, our podcast likes to cover the idea that like we are our own worst enemy. So we get in our way and we get in like each other's way. Like for example, me and Elliot, we both get in our own heads about the state of things constantly.
Whether people
and it stops
like
us
me.
From acting.
I just want to be liked.
I just want everybody to like me.
I mean,
some of them.
Yeah, the cool ones.
A few of them.
Dylan, you don't.
I mean,
to
like one person. There's only one person that I really want.
Really? Yeah.
It's Andy. It's Andy.
Andy, love me.
Love us, Andy.
Yeah, I find I have a similar problem with getting Dylan to love you.
Or getting into your head.
Should we talk about why Ben Shapiro loving Blade Runner is wrong, or?
Well, or we can just talk about. Why conservatives liking The Matrix and doing the pill reference is wrong as well.
Right. We gotta take the red pill, and then... Oh, man, what a dude bro fucking macho. Don't go to r/dude bro. Just don't go there.
Just save yourself.
It's just like, man, I started being an asshole, and the women just flocked to my door.
Andy says it's as much about getting in my own head. I've just always struggled to stay productive. Oh, not as much about getting in my head. Just struggling to stay productive.
Yeah, I get that too. Just got to make it fun. Just go to r/aww.
Goes there immediately. See, that's what's gonna happen. We're gonna say no.
We're gonna drive people away to r/aww.
You're not gonna listen to Dad.
Dad, you got to keep people here, man. You got to think of the algorithm. Oh man. So yeah, I do that too. Like where I procrastinate, and then like I see everyone's sleep schedule slowly inverting. Like I watch Sonic slowly like ruin his sleep schedule, and then Jeffy's just like going to bed at 10 a.m. and waking up.
I'm getting up at 6:30 in the morning.
Then you're like, you only wake up at a reasonable hour if you're with your girlfriend.
Yeah,
I go to bed at 4 and I fucking wake up at 9. I don't see what the fucking problem is.
I mean, 5 hours is good enough for me. That's actually kind of preferred for me.
Whatever.
You know, okay, so on this whole idea of being productive, right, I found that one of the issues that I personally have with being productive is that, you start a project, you start working on something, you're drawing something or whatever, and you get a little bit of hype about it, right? And you kind of rest on your laurels as a result of it, and you don't keep the train going, which is one of my problems, where it's just like, hey, I did a cool thing. And then instead of continuing to do the cool thing, I'm sitting on like that hype of the thing that whatever I just did, and I wait a little too long, and then I'm not in the mind state to continue to be productive. Like I ruined it by not just continuing to move, which I feel like you have to keep.
Wait,
moving.
You're like, man, that thing I made, that was so great.
Like, well, it, like not like, you know, like absolutely like I made this wonderful thing. It's my magnum opus. No, like I'm saying, like
Holland.
Yeah, I'm Matisse. But anyways, like you know what I'm saying though, Elliot. Where you're like, hey, this is cool. I've completed something, but you have to keep on the train of doing whatever it is you want to get done, right? Like I'll finish a song, and I'll feel happy that it's done. But instead of working on the next song in the next few days, I'll take a long enough break that I'm not continuing to push through.
Gotcha.
You know, I'm not keeping it going.
I'm in a different thing there because I'm so like happy if I get anything done. It's But yeah, that's. I mean, I can see where you're coming from. Staying productive. So.
Well, Elliot, it's why I do so much.
Shut my brain off and go to sleep. So when I bad sleep nights, my mind goes through something normal about balancing my budget. Andy, you can talk. Andy, can you talk to Dreamer about the budget?
So you're like jumping from bad scenario to bad scenario, right?
I used to do that, and there I don't know what fixed it, but sometimes I still do. Like if I'm feeling like regret, I'll do it. Like I just like, oh, it's time to go to sleep, and I can't shut my brain off. So I think now I just get so fucking exhausted by staying up till 4 a.m. and then I sleep. So I am losing sleep because of it, I guess. I'm in the same kind of field there. My friend's stepdad, who was has been a mentor to me, told me that there are two kinds of perfectionists. Perfectionists in the conventional sense, where everything has to be just so. And the big brain perfectionists, where if I just never do anything, I can screw it up. Can't fail if I never start. I'm in the second category there. Fear of failure's all you started. Verdicts in. Anyway, go listen to Queens of the Stone Age. And that's true in my mind a lot of times.
We got a lot of ground to cover here.
I do need to make a budget emote. Hell yeah. Not if we make one first. That's never going to happen.
Okay,
I'll do that now or after this TikTok. Oh, man.
So I think we should talk a little bit about what Dreamer's mentioned and then go on to what Andy has mentioned, because there's actually a lot here.
Thank you so much for the discussion.
Yes, much appreciated. I'd rather fail than never. See, yeah. that's the boat I'm in, where it's like,
right. I'm in the other one.
I have to constantly do stuff. If I'm not doing anything, I'm just
it's a waste. Hell yeah.
But I have a question though, Dreamer. So if you're having this chain of potentially negative thoughts, right? If this is too personal, you don't have to answer. But do you spend a lot of time throughout the day, thinking about what's gonna happen next, just in the day, in the week? Do you spend a lot of your time thinking about the future?
First attempt in learning. Dreamer, while we're waiting for responses, failure is just success training.
And
I try to tell myself that, but I spent the last 10 years plus, with fear of, failure, not even start, failure to start. And now it's just over the last 2 years, I've started my own business, which is now struggling because of COVID. I'm doing this now, which is just something to do while I can't do my business and while I can't, enjoy the warm weather. This is just whatever. So I'm doing something rather than nothing. I could not Twitch stream and just sit on my ass, or I could do this. Those are the options. So I'm starting to trick myself into doing stuff, and it's I've gotten so much done for in terms of show art and sound stuff and getting slobs working, because it's something fun, and I realize if it's something I want to do. I don't need to worry about staying motivated. I need to worry about, taking a break.
Mm-hmm.
You just flexing on everybody with your casual 15-hour...
you flexing on people with casual 15-hour... Well,
something I
that's
like,
how we started.
Something I like to do is just... That's not a big deal. It's just a reason to not eat for 15 hours, you know what I mean?
If I play the game for 15 hours, I accomplish my other goals. I just think that's productive.
I'm fasting as well, so making a TikTok. So if you guys reply from Squidville Live, it's me. I'm still here.
Oh, okay.
If you get a reply. Yeah, okay. Okay.
We will know.
I'll do that.
See?
Here I am. Ban Squidville Live.
Ban.
Oh, yo. Andy never gets a shout out because that's not who he is. This is his alter ego.
I wouldn't say outside of normal planning. I've dealt with this for years, so I have a bit of a system.
Go.
But normally what starts...
Seriously, go check out Squidville Live.
I would sometimes... Yes, definitely.
It's the best fucking mower simulator. Oh. It's what all the cool kids are doing.
Is this your superhero disguise?
Yeah, when
Squidville Live.
He fucking rips open the shirt and it's not budget, man. It's Squidville Live.
The live's got to be in all caps. Squidville Live.
Time for a refill.
So sometimes you get a random thought and that you don't like, and you wonder why you got it.
Ooh, yeah.
Ooh, that goes a lot deeper than what I was originally thinking may have been the case, because I know a lot of people who think about potential futures throughout the entire day, and it does plague their sleep a lot because
crazy.
Oh, and like your dreams as well.
What ifs? What if the fucking sun explodes? Live in the now. I mean, I think
yeah,
I
yeah. Can... Live in the now.
What ifs? Okay, I understand. I'm understanding.
Yeah. Well, it sounds like, and I may be wrong, Dreamer, but it sounds like you're more concerned about why the thought came up in the first place, as opposed to having a personality in which is perceptible to thinking about the future and concerns, which is totally different, in my opinion.
Dad, you're giving me an idea for the movie that we have to write. We're writing a movie this episode.
How many squids are there?
Yeah, it's squid. It's called Squidville Live or Squidville Nights, right? And that's
Squidville
it. Like,
Nights.
But then you find out that Squidville Live is actually like, it's squids. It's just the town of squids, man. We're gonna have to write it later.
Oh, I for some reason what popped in my head was a movie where like, it just features Andy and Dylan, and one of them wants to be the Squidville superhero, but the other one's like, you got to be rational. You can't be a superhero. It's like one of those movies where like somebody has a delusion, right? And then they finally get to be what it is they said they wanted to be. There's like that one weird moment where it happens. You know what I'm talking about? It's almost like an Adam Sandler film.
Or okay, are they saying neither? Like okay, one of them wants to be Squidville Live, the hero, and one of them's like, hey man, you gotta be rational. Or how
you
about
you can't be the
how about they're fighting
man.
Over who has to be the sidekick? And Andy's like, clearly, clearly, I have the beard of a superhero.
And then they just look at Noah. What do you think? Noah just shrugs, and then just that's
all
it.
All hail Cthulhu! I'm hoping like a game show that like. The big reveal is like the dude takes off his mask and he's a fucking Squidville, like he's a squidite. Fucking Andy pulls off the skin and it's just like surprise, motherfuckers.
And then is at the end of the movie like it's been a trick the entire time.
Yeah, but like it's a dude playing a game show, right? And then like, but the big reveal at the end is like, oh my god, the presenter's a squid, and then like the hostess, she's a squid, and then like the fucking.
I'm squid. Are there any other Squidvilles I should know?
They like the audience is also all squids because they never stop cheering. They're like, why is no one like a gasp? And then they slowly like all their masks come off and they're just like they're all squids. So there's gonna be like
and
the
it
slow.
Was just a Twilight Zone episode.
Yes, and the William Shatner's on the wing the whole time.
Oh jeez, I honestly,
you're a Squidville. I'm a Squidville.
Oh, I love that episode of SpongeBob. But, like, I honestly think the one thing that this movie needs is constant references to, like, Noah and his opinions, but he only shows up, like, once in the movie at the very end. Like, Noah's there.
He's got the Silent Bob, like, talking moment.
Yeah, just the one moment. Like, Noah's been there the whole time.
Noah's done been there.
Been there the whole time.
No. They finally pan over to Noah, and he fucking takes his fucking mask off, and he's the Squidville Live.
Wait, was he up there on the Empire State Building while they were fighting? Yeah, Noah was there. Was that kick-ass?
See, Dreamers, don't try to get back to the topic. But seriously, that's good to hear. Make no mistake, just want to make it clear, I'm in good mental health. Just when this stuff happens, I tend to obsess over to why it happened, and have to work on myself back to normal, but I'm able to do it. Well, that's do you ground yourself? Like grounding, I hear that's a good, like if you're having an anxiety attack, you're just like, well, touch this desk, it feels smooth, touch this bottle, it feels coarse, like here's a cold compress, feel the cold on the skin. I've had to ground people who are having, like, anxiety attacks. It helps.
Oh, you mean panic attacks?
Well, yeah, but, like, not full-on. I mean, this and that.
I think medically they're only called panic attacks, but...
Right, but, I mean, it's not, like, a full-on, like...
It's not what you would consider, like, your stereotypical panic attack.
Yeah, they
right?
never get that bad, but, like, it's basically just like, okay, so who am I? What are we doing? Where are we going?
Mm-hmm.
Hold my hand.
I'm trying not to interrupt you, but I wanted to make it clear that I didn't make any assumptions about your mental health. I was just wondering about the thought process. Oh, I guess I missed that part because I didn't think anything.
I'm fucking with you. I didn't either. I thought you're fine.
I was going to say.
Dreamer, you're fine. You're doing great.
Yeah.
Shout out, Dreamer. That's the twist. I was the squid this entire time.
I do have a grounding system for my depression when I have overthinking issues. I've also developed a system for when my wife... Ah, okay.
Ooh. For when the wife attacks, right? No?
I stopped because I was just like, is this a bit?
Well, my coping mechanism is to make everything a joke. Because, I mean, Comedy's very therapeutic, but
yeah,
like also just like, I don't know, like when I don't have rage quits, I just have like laughing attacks, like, oh my god, this was so great, how could everything fuck up so royally, like everything fucked up all like perfectly, what are the
Elliot
odds?
Closes the door to his apartment and just like, starts laughingly laughing.
I pull my
just
mask
like
off
the, and under the darkness of like a really really shitty bulb.
I was the squid the whole time.
I get a little bit of nervous laughter too, to be honest.
It's not nervous. Like, I don't think it's.
Oh, for me, it's nervous laughter. It's.
Well, it was none. It was more letting everyone know I'm okay. I wanted Elliot. I warned Elliot. I come from a family of mental illness. Oh, dude.
I do as well.
Dude. I'm sorry, all the green text Chrono Cross viewers kind of jumbled together. I'm really sorry, Dreamers, but Dreamers was telling me about his grandmother disappearing while having a stage 4 schizophrenic episode.
Yeah.
And then, like, his grandfather, I think his grandfather, like, or his aunt disappeared. His grandfather had, like, aunt, yeah, okay. His grandfather, like, I still have connections to the CIA, I found her. Like,
yeah.
This was nuts. We could just have Dreamer on to talk about shit, but then they might put one in his head.
Oh, jeez. So. Like, wow. That's a lot deeper than just a general history of mental health.
Oh, yeah. I'm like, I didn't understand that schizophrenia had, like, I guess it, like, I'd assume there's, like, varying severities of cases.
Oh, yeah, yeah, definitely.
But, like, okay, there's stage 4. Like, dude, she just forgets who she is. She went to France and started a new life. Like.
Oh, wow, really?
She's been in trouble with the law. I don't want to,
Well, yeah, you can't, yeah, this is for.
But, like, nobody knows names and stuff, so.
Yeah.
But, like, I'm like, dude, did she murder somebody? No, like, we've had to bring her files to the courthouse, though, and be like, this is, she's pleading insanity, this is insane.
This is way more intense than that time I watched my dad snort cocaine.
Did he write you a letter from the scallop boat?
No, he was right there in front of me, it was right before
Dear
a family reunion.
Odious Rungus.
But, geez, that's intense. Well, because okay, so what I found out, because I've been funneled a lot of like new information about psychology, because my sister is into psychology, like she goes to university and stuff for that. So like she tells me how things have changed a bit, because there's a lot of like past misconceptions that people still think, and one of them is that there used to be types for schizophrenia, right? Okay. But now everything's on a spectrum. They've changed it to a spectrum as opposed to like, you know, mixed type, paranoid. There was like 3 or 4 types prior to this.
Okay, paranoid, schizophrenia. Okay.
Yeah, and now it's on a spectrum, just like most things are. Just because psychology is so weird that you can't really just type it out.
Is that a left right, or is there like an up and down too?
I believe it's just a left right. I think it's like a your general what would you call it? Yeah, your general spectrum as opposed to like a quadrant system or anything like that.
Okay.
When I say my family, I don't mean my family. Well, yeah, like I mean, we jury find the defendant not guilty by degree of insanity. Ah, okay. Well, the thing is about like the term crazy. I think that's now really just a general adjective for somebody who like works outside of your general functioning, right? It doesn't even have any medical meaning to it anymore.
Let me introduce my three uncles. There's just one guy here. Yeah. Curly, Larry, and Mo. I'm here all night.
Elliot, I think that you would really enjoy I know you prefer like to like do audiobooks, right?
Yeah.
You prefer those. Okay. I think you should try to get a hold of The History of Madness. I think you'd really enjoy it by Michel Foucault. It basically is a dissertation, but it's like readable, not like fucking academic dissertation. style about the history of legitimately madness. Like, it starts with like how people used to be revered as like sages.
First of all, the fucking cover art is enough to get me hooked.
Isn't it awesome? Like the painting and like the, yeah, it's really cool. Own the book, but it's a thick boy.
It's a thick boy.
It's a real thick. It's a thick boy. It's like a, know if it's like Kindle a 700, 800, it's thick boy.
Kindle version's pretty cheap, but like, why are there three Kindle, rent it.
Are you on Amazon with it?
Right, yeah.
Could you please link it to people in chat? Just in case, because like, this is materials like we're talking about, so if they want to look it up.
Copy pasta. I got to find an audiobook for it. Because
there's gotta be.
My eyes hurt. No, I just
he was a very famous French philosopher.
Is that whole like I'm an audible learner, I'm an auditory learner, I'm a visual learner? Is that a thing?
It's bullshit.
That's what I thought.
You want me to talk a little bit about that?
Yes, please, because I'm still under the I do take things better when I hear them, I guess.
Okay, so the reason it's BS is because in education, it's been pushed, and then now we're trying to push back against it because everybody is actually capable, unless of course there is legitimately something that's preventing you from learning from a certain like form of material as a result of like, you know, you're deaf or whatnot, right? There's legitimately something. Everybody can learn from any style. However, if you push yourself in one direction, you tend to avoid other forms and not get better at them as a result, even though you're fully capable of learning those ways. Like, a lot of people say, hey, I'm visual, I can't do anything with the visuals, which is, it's us lying to ourselves because we're so used to preferring a method. That's what it is that you could go in any direction and learn just as well. Although, it depends on the material too. Like in language, you really want to be hearing as much as you can.
God.
You really want to be listening, because it doesn't matter how much you like practice speaking. It doesn't matter how much you practice writing or whatnot. If you're not listening, like conversations are just going to go real bad. But basically it's obnoxious is what it is. That whole learning styles thing.
Oh, geez.
There's a lot more in-depth information on it, but to answer your question, yeah, just train yourself in the other learning styles if you want to. There's a societal version of being called crazy, which means anyone that does anything outside of person. Exactly, that's what I was talking about, is that crazy is generally just considered that now, which is unfortunate because it does have a past history of being negative and being used towards people who actually do have mental illnesses, right? But for the most part, it has that general meaning where it's just like, you're crazy because you do something that I wouldn't do, or, you know, or makes me uncomfortable. Which is unfortunate because, like, here's another topic, Elliot. When does passion become obsession?
Definitely at the Howard Hughes level.
Does
passion become obsession? When you start to, like, find yourself outside of her window at various hours.
Even with the rocks in the boombox?
In the boombox, in the click-clacks. Yeah.
In the click-clacks, in the boombox, in the boom-boom. Because that sounds not really romantic at all. Somebody blasting an 80s or something tape outside monkey. Your window.
You picked the wrong Peter Gabriel song. Fucking South Park bit. Do I have double audio this whole time?
Not that I know of. Or if you have, nobody has been concerned about it.
Oh my god.
When you're willing to accept harm or negative repercussions. I think that's definitely an element of it. I was going to go towards the when your social life is...
Double headphones.
When you determine that everything in your social life needs to relate to whatever it is you're passionate about, also might be a sign of obsession.
Right.
However, if you think about it, a lot of famous thinkers, I almost feel like were like that as a result of like that consuming their lifestyle. I remember stories of, I don't know if anybody's heard of Ludwig Wittgenstein. He was a philosopher, and he wrote like the Tractatus and whatnot. Tractatus Logico-Philosophicus, I think it was called, where he tried to make all of philosophy into the concept of language games. So basically, he was just saying anything you do is usually just a language game. Like, you're just using different terms and different words and stuff to get to pretty much the same concepts. And he wasn't necessarily wrong. But when he became a teacher, I think he got fired or quit really quickly because he didn't understand why his students wouldn't understand the stuff he was talking about, to the point where he was quite verbally abusive, because he was absolutely obsessed with his field.
Oh, geez.
So, like, there's even an obscure, like, film about him, and I remember there was a scene where he's, like, teaching math or something, this little kid, and he's just yelling. So, like, there's even an obscure, like, what's that now? Oh, now I'm hearing your, audio of the audio from the past through my headphones.
Okay, this is weird. Yeah, that's weird.
But of course,
these headphones are crazy loud.
Perhaps Wittgenstein's not as good of a case.
Well, that happens.
As Socrates,
I might have had
though.
Doubled audio. I'll never know until I listen to it back. But
because I know that Elliot knows this bit, about Socrates and his necessity to ask questions to powerful people in like the plaza and stuff, like just to keep asking questions of people who are way higher in status than him.
Oh, Ludwig Johann was an Austrian British philosopher who worked primarily in logic, the philosophy of mathematicians mind, and
yes,
I am so like I am not well versed in philosophy.
Okay, well, that's why I'm like, I'm trying to get out of the.
Oh, hey, next time I have double audio, could somebody like tell me?
That'd be pretty... Well, no, Dreamer said you've had no double audio since they've been here.
Derp. It's just I have two fucking sound sources, so.
So, I'm trying to like not really get into the thick of the philosophy as much as like. The general idea, because like imagine there's this guy, right? He's not like super high in the totem pole, but he's just going to the market and he's talking to like all the people who are way above his status and asking them tough questions, right?
Okay.
Like, you know, like basically insulting them by constantly questioning them. Like another question leads to another question, and that's part of the whole Socratic method, right?
Right.
Isn't that obsession with questioning because he's actually disrupting social order and going outside of that norm to the extent that it probably was the reason why he had to kill himself, right? Because remember, Socrates ended up drinking the poison, right? The hemlock.
Did they make him do that, or was that his choice?
That was his punishment, and he accepted it because there's also a story about his friend going there and trying to plead with him that like actually he does more good being alive, right. However, Socrates believed that if the state, because the state had like had given him so much, right, had given him a place to live, had given him friends, it had given him like safety, right? So he determined that by the law there that it was the rightful punishment for him to die because he was there and they had given him so much, right? So the just law is whatever the law states it to be. So he had to end his own life.
Okay.
That's
crazy.
Yeah. It's very insane. And by insane, I mean it's crazy in the sense of it's not what I would do.
Right.
Like the definition that Dreamer had mentioned.
Okay. But so what was his actual crime, though?
Okay, his crime was because he basically... The gist is he was asking questions and talking so much that the city, the state believed that he was corrupting the youth.
Oh.
And he was influencing thought. And like I said, his friends apparently tried to bust him out. And by that, I mean, there was a story from, I believe, you know, Plato, his student, wrote this little like dialogue between him and Socrates, between not Plato and Socrates, but Socrates and one of his friends, about him basically saying, hey, we can bust you out of here easily. We can leave. It's no big deal. And Socrates was just like, no, man, if I leave, it's unjust.
Yeah, that's the snippet I just got off of Google. So, but poisoning yourself, oh man, that's not a classy way to go.
Exactly, Dreamer. Yeah, that's exactly, yeah.
To like have your body slowly shut down from poison is just not.
I think the dosage was pretty damn high.
Yeah, but like, what shuts down first? Does it hit your kidneys? Does it hit your liver?
Well, it depends on the type of toxin it is, and I've only really like looked into insect toxins, so I'm not sure.
It's pronounced Socrates.
It's pronounced Socrates.
I've heard it a few. Socrates, Socrates.
Yeah.
Socratic.
I'm just gonna say that I'm a descriptivist linguist, particularly an applied linguist, and any available
podcast.
Pronunciation.
Hey, there's another goddamn podcast in here trying to push a shit in about Socrates. Get out of here, fire resistance. What are you talking about?
No, how you doing?
Hey, yeah, how you doing? I'm just fucking with you.
Oh, no, yeah, we're just messing with you. Hopefully you're doing well.
Oh, this looks cool. Fire resistance podcast is, man, what are you...
Just leaves.
I see some shenanigans here.
No, I just,
The Beard and Urn Show. Let's give fucking shout outs to.
Yeah, we gotta shout you out.
Go check out
Yeah, go. We haven't seen your stuff, but we're definitely gonna look now.
The Beard and the Urn Show. Topics. Wrestling and Jesus. Oh, that's what we talk about.
Wrestling and Jesus.
Everything between wrestling and Jesus.
So I feel like I have to clarify here, Fire, that Elliot here has been pushing my shit in about pronunciation like every step of the way, right? So I feel like I have to put on my linguist badge constantly. So yeah, I guess I'm a little like I'm a little perturbed by it, but oh, it's all good and fun.
Do you mean Andy of Squidville fame?
Andy.
Andy of
You will get a follow soon from Famous Andy. Famous Andy's?
Famous
That's
Andy.
A restaurant, no?
Hell yeah.
Famous Andy's Barbecue
it's,
Pit?
It's a Christian wrestling podcast.
I'm from Texas. Well, I'm in Texas. We don't pronounce anything correctly. According to a Texas variety, a Texan variety, you do. But there's so much linguist stuff that I'd like to talk about, but here's not really the place to go heavily into that.
I missed it. Not good to go heavily into what?
He's trying to build his stupid TikTok brand at the moment. Rolls eyes. Oh. I'm sorry, but Famous Andy's Barbecue Pit, just like that famous place around here, just sounds like a legitimate...
What are we not talking about?
I was saying that because Fire had said I'm in Texas, we don't pronounce anything correctly, and I said, well, we can talk about, you know, varieties and whatnot, but that's really heavy in the linguistic stuff, and that's not what this podcast is about.
Yeah, this podcast is about shoveling snow. You've come to the right spot. Now, when when you're shoveling snow here in Michigan, you gotta lift with your back. No, you bend over, right? You straighten your legs, and when you lift, you give a sharp twisting motion. From Georgia,
some torsion.
I'm not sure what I speak is an actual language.
Well, I can assure you that both you and Fire speak appropriate varieties of English, regardless of where you're from.
Yeah, dude, I can't hear an accent at all. Your text is clear as a bell. I love. I'm obsessed with the Yorkshire accent. That's got like it's not just an accent, but it's like a whole vernacular. Because Patrick Stewart is from Yorkshire, and he's like, man, if I want to make it in acting, I got to drop this bullshit. So now he speaks with more of like the Queen's
now
English.
Listen, y'all. Like, who is this in particular?
Listen, we just turned into an ice cube a week ago. Listen, y'all.
Do what now?
Do what now?
Oh.
I'm talking about Patrick Stewart being from Yorkshire.
Yeah, okay. So I'm sorry, you cut out for me for like half a second, and I didn't catch the name.
Patrick Stewart. Jean-Luc Picard of the USS Enterprise. But also other roles, too. Like Dune. One of my favorites.
Engage.
The spice melange must flow. Speaking of spice melange, nobody's redeeming those channel points.
Nobody's redeeming the channel points.
Not at all. But you know what?
It don't matter.
Oh, shit. I prefer this when we're flying over Vietnam, as we often do. Don't look at me, I only have 10. Well, stay a while, put your feet up.
Yeah, I just got here. I only have 10.
We're just talking about mental health.
Mental health, and we were talking about when does passion become obsession?
Passion becomes, man. What's the fine line? Wait, how? Because I could certainly see... I mean,
go on. Dreamer brought up a good point that has a lot, like, there's an element of it where you start to accept harm and negative consequences for whatever it is you're passionate about. And I had also referenced that when you start to disrupt social norms in the way that everything that you communicate about is related to your passion is also probably an element of obsession.
But isn't that the whole, like, no pain, no gain, macho dude bro mentality? Or those like, where they're like, hey, like, pain is pain. Like, don't, yeah, you should probably stop if it hurts.
Well, yeah, but I mean, like, think about, like, if you, for example, because a lot of people who become very obsessed are just particularly become obsessed with, like, fitness, right?
Escapism for being bullied. Man, I've been bullied in fucking 12 years.
Most of us come to video games as escape from being bullied. Okay, you know, there actually is a little bit of that. And that, I think, spreads into a lot of different things that people become not necessarily obsessed with, because we're still trying to decide whether or not passion...
It's been 25 years since I've been bullied. Yeah, dude, 6'3 at 3 bills in high school, you don't get bullied often.
Yeah, I was going to say... I went to the bank and they bullied me.
So I took the pens.
They made me open a savings account.
They called me fatty, so I took all their dum-dums. I took two dum-dums and they're like, hey, fatty, those are for everyone. So I took them all.
I took all the dum-dums.
I ripped the chains off the pens and then I got tackled by a security
guard. I opened every single one of them, licked all of them, and then shoved them up the air tube.
I'm like, now they're all mystery flavor, you dick. Oh, man.
I yelled, stop bullying me.
Cuts me off in traffic. Yelled, stop bullying me.
When you are willing to forego your responsibility and maintain a functional life is when passion... That's definitely a part of it.
Right.
Yeah,
but
give us
an
example.
I want to find, like, the thin line. Like, okay.
Oh.
Obviously, like, you're losing sleep or, like, when... I want to get into the darkness of it. Like,
you want the real controversial opinion, not
like,
the,
when,
hey, man, it's when your life is it.
Right, but when does Jessica, like, call the police? Is it the first hair doll or is it the second hair doll?
Oh, yeah. Like, is it still obsession if you're doing everything in life, but, like, what it is you do, like, you do it constantly at home? You know, like, the weird thing?
I'm obsessed with getting 8 hours of sleep, brushing my teeth 3 times a day, eating my vegetables.
Oh, that's another thing. Can it be obsession still if it's a mundane thing?
Like, oh, man.
Of course, it's a schedule, right?
Like
you can be obsessed
with
schedules.
You can overhydrate. You can overbrush your teeth if we're going to go down that line. What can you over-obsess about? I mean, like, what point does that become, like, what's that disorder where you have to, like, touch the doorknob three times before you turn the
stove? Obsessive compulsive disorder?
Yeah, thank you. Thank you. Well, then it is obsessive.
Yeah, but that's like a legitimate, like, psychological, like, where I'm talking about, like, hey, man,
obsession and passion,
you need to stop telling people about your toenail collection kind of thing. Like,
why did I think toenails as soon as we're like...
I did too. I immediately did, because I think the media that we've consumed...
Mine was like boring.
...has mentioned, like, lint collection and all that shit.
Idolatry. I mean, I'd prefer to use science terms, but okay.
Well... Idolatry. Yeah, I've heard the term before.
Because then we could actually treat it with, like, medicine and therapy.
And those things.
But that's just me.
Yo, humans like toenails.
I know, it's weird. Like,
you humans like... Oh, yeah, that's right. Neon's not human.
Medicine.
Of course, yeah. Like, I wouldn't doubt that you weren't for medicine.
Oh, I did. You
did?
I got the cut of his... Yeah, like, this guy... I saw him. I'm like, this guy fucking hates medicine.
And I'm just like, hey, I don't know anything about
this
fire.
This dude with this fucking awesome beard hates... You guys, seriously, go check out Fire Resistant.
Yeah,
Pocket.
Go check,
like,
him out.
That beard is sick, dude.
I didn't... Andy
from Squidville fame, you have competition, sir.
All things in moderation. That's the thing, though. Like, Andy, you say
guy,
all things in moderation.
Guy.
And I get that. My problem is the need to know
science,
like,
is... I know, Neon.
More.
I saw by the emote. Science is religion, though. Yeah, man. I'm gonna get together my fucking...
The young guy, not the older guy.
I'm gonna get my Bunsen burners together, dude. I'm gonna fucking arrange my beakers in a pentagram. And then I'm gonna write down the results. Still, nothing happened. Day 37 of summoning Baphomet. Nothing has happened.
I recently got some cobalt samples, and I was thinking I'd sacrifice them to the Big Bang.
Yeah, dude. Here, can you lick this, and then we're gonna go incubate it, and then, you gotta stop drinking when I'm about to say some funny shit. Neon 2, history science is, but observational isn't. Hail science. History science is religion, but observational science isn't. Yeah, I'm joking, Fire.
Oh, do you mean like the not some of the nonsensical things that people have come to best in the here?
Like,
history?
I'm under the assumption that religion is like the worship of a higher power, and science is not a higher power. It's a method of understanding.
Yeah, because it doesn't have grounding in anything like that. It's completely it's a methodology for understanding.
Can we talk about people being anti-science? Like, it's literally just the process of trying to understand shit. Like, there's nothing like, hey, I was wrong. Like, my peers said I was wrong. They did the work. They recreated the experiment, and they found out, like, through testing and testing and testing, that I was
God
wrong.
Damn it, Nathan.
Moving on now. I go to science church and pray to Charles Darwin. Oh my god. Speaking of, you know that Richard Dawkins coined the term meme in his in one of his 70s books? It's from the Greek, like, meme.
Is that a...
Meme-mimia? M-I-M-E-M-E. M-I-M-E-M-E. Yeah.
Jeez, I think I know the name of that book.
Mimima. Yeah.
Is it the... It's not. That's too new, isn't it? Is it the Watchmakers?
I could look it up.
Is that that one?
Richard Dawkins. My boy Dawkins.
There's, like... I do have a little bit of beef with Richard Dawkins, though.
Air that beef, man.
I think his method for getting people to understand where he's coming from is sometimes so no nonsense that it's actually not effective, and it's doing the opposite of what it's intended to do.
Say that again, but the selfish gene. One more time.
I was saying that sometimes his methodology for getting people to try to understand where he's coming from is far too abrasive to be effective. It's the lack of using rhetoric in the right means to apply logic to a person's thinking.
Here's the thing, though. It takes all types. You know, like, it takes Malcolm X to make you listen to it takes Malcolm X to make you listen to MLK. Like... He's playing more of a bit. Like, he is the abrasive grumpy old atheist, because us atheists tend to not be... We tend to be a little too, like, respectful at times and just, like, willing to go with it.
Well, see, that's the thing. I know it takes all types. Like, I mean, clearly we need, like, we need our Bill Burrs and stuff in comedy and stuff, you know, who just, like, right from the get-go are aggro, like Nathan saying, I like, mean, you know.
People respond differently. Some people need a wake-up check. Some people need a fucking turn-down service.
A blind watchmaker, yeah. Which I think you had mentioned.
Yeah, but this selfish gene is where the term meme gets.
The selfish gene? Okay, yeah. That's older than the, I think.
That's from 76. From the bicentennial.
Sometimes it's true you do, like Ellie was saying, you do need that, like, to break through a wall, but sometimes you'll break the wall and you'll find that all you've done is revealed a much stronger wall that the hammer is now useless against.
Right.
Because you didn't take time.
I mean, I don't like, see... I guess, yeah, he can be a grumpy old man, but it's like, I think it's super refreshing to hear someone, like, actually adamantly proselytizing to, like, hey, man, this is straight-up bullshit. We can't sugarcoat this anymore. This is bullshit. Like... That's not he goes over like the detriment of religion more than anything. Like, where is it dangerous?
Well, he's also in the softest quote unquote hard science out there as well, because biology is actually just physics and chemistry.
Nathan, I unsubscribed from our atheism like years ago. That is a cesspool. It's just,
it probably became one, didn't it?
Well, I mean, yeah. Well, most of the big subreddits are just meme. Meme. We don't have r/atheism.
What if Epicurus? Yeah.
Oh man.
Epicurus is like
I just got so much shit to Google now.
Basically, I'm just gonna call Epicurus soft hedonism is what I would describe his theory as.
God, Chet,
because. Man. To be an Epicurean is basically to understand enjoying life in a moderate, like, in moderation, through simple means, like enjoying simple cheeses and breads and stuff and wine and having discussion and doing what you want, but with this healthy moderation. Whereas hedonism is like enjoying all the best things constantly, right? Just participating in how would I explain it?
Okay, like, I love this one. I love this. Is God willing to prevent evil but not able? There he is not omnipotent.
Okay,
is
then he's not yet.
Is he able but not willing? There he's not malevolent. Is he born both able and willing? Then whence cometh evil? Is that neither able nor willing? Then why call him God? Yeah, I love that. Yeah. I mean, there's a great poem by the amazing atheist. But, I mean, there's a great line in it where it's like, are you good because you're God, or are you God because you're good? And it's a nice little... It's along that line of... It's one of my favorite poems.
I can't remember... there was also another theist and philosopher
who had
mentioned...
I understand,
Nathan. Yeah, I figured there was a lot of sarcasm in there.
Yeah, it's
a
shithole.
Who basically said that Satan couldn't exist... He was... He believed in God.
Oh, and also God knew it was going to happen, so...
Yeah, well, he believed that he came to the terms that Satan, or the Prince of Darkness in his case, could not exist simply because God is supposed to be pure good. So how could he generate something evil from himself? So he believed in a form of Christianity, basically, where there was no evil side to it. You couldn't go to a hell. You couldn't meet a Satan because God is innately good.
Right. I gotta go tend to secret things. Is this baby related? Anyway, I like chat questions for chat. Can God make a hot pocket so hot that he can't even eat it? It's that stupid. Can he make a boulder so
could he
microwave, like, a hot pocket so hot that it would burn his mouth? Because then he's
could he
not,
change the meta of being a god?
If he cannot, he is not omnipotent. And if he can, then he is not omnipotent. It's a stupid fucking... Neon, fucking tuck your balls, tit fucker. Keep your stick on the ice. Neon, he's trying so hard. Like, good luck, I hate kids. And then he's...
Well, if you do have to head out, though, have a good day.
Drive safe.
Things are good.
Look out for drop bears.
Would you like a vague explanation of that? Which of the concepts, Dreamer, like, you can just give us an explanation regardless, because we've been going pretty ham on a lot of stuff here, so.
Oh, we've been slaloming like fucking gold medalists over here.
Maybe we need to, like, talk about philosophers and stuff a lot, because they seem to generate a lot of conversation.
Are drop bears poisonous or venomous? You gotta look at the fangs.
Have you ever seen a snipe before?
Oh, yeah. I'm out here hunting snipe.
I've got my snipe trap.
Those damn blue-collared tweakers are the backbone of this town. shouts to Primus. Can I just have a bunch of Primus sound clips? No one's stopping
me. You technically could. Yeah. I mean, isn't there like just like a 10-second? There's like a limit or something. But
yeah, all of mine are 11. So
all of mine are turned up to 11. It's a Spinal Tap reference.
No. All of mine are like 11 seconds or over.
Oh, I see.
I'm skating that edge.
You need to, when you're in my stream, you need to use the schedule command.
Okay.
So you can see my schedule.
I already know it, but okay.
I know you know it. But
oh, you want me to see that funny joke?
Yeah, it's a funny ha-has.
I'm going to go until I turn the... Oh.
Due to the sinful phrase you just spat out, heathen.
Okay. You do you, boo-boo.
Well, seriously, if you do have to go, have a good one.
Oh, man. Well, I'm so glad we turned this nothing burger of a podcast into good conversation, because... We ended up talking about religion anyway. It just took a fucking Christian wrestling boy to bring it out of us.
It just took that and like a ton of conversation about philosophers and such. But I really want to return to the point, like, if you were in that position, Elliot, where you're sitting there and you're on trial and your friends are going to come bust you out, but the other option is to stay and be quote unquote ethical and drink the poison, I'm sorry, I'd leave. I think the state would be wrong.
Oh, then you're gonna be exiled. Well, okay, so is it what's the alternative if you leave? Could he have left?
I think he just would never be able to return to Athens.
Okay, so does his love of his city, like,
I think, yeah, his love of the city was his big thing.
Is exile worse than death? Like,
I guess if you're so passionate.
According
about
the to
city,
the Bible, there are a few brief descriptions that we may retain a sense of who we are, and have a sense of free will. Lucifer chose to go against God, as well as I have his own followers. Well, okay, I'm going to talk about free will in a moment. Lucifer had to make the choice himself, just because God knew. It would happen. That's a whole thing. Like, even Judas and Jesus knew someone would betray him, so he went to his best friend Judas and said, "You will betray me, my son." Like he knew, like, bro, I need somebody to betray me so I can fucking resurrect. So Judas is not the bad guy of the Bible. He's like, he just pushed the stone, like. Judas wasn't like, fuck Jesus of Nazareth. He's like, oh man, Jesus needs to have me do him dirty. And that's it. But to my thing, free will, like, there isn't... I mean, I like the theory that there is no free will. And it's not because of a religious thing. It's because
I'm on the other side.
Oh, that there is free will?
Yeah.
Well, then I'll try to convince you. Like, so, I mean...
Do
I have the free will strong enough to not drink this and slowly let myself dehydrate to death? Do I have that willpower? Like, do I have the willpower to break out of my own, like, norm? Or I think things are in such a way that, like, we are such creatures of habit that, yeah, you can kind of, like, break out of your regular thing, but, like, you're not gonna, like,
so
you're not
does the
you're
person
not,
who goes on a hunger strike are they
I mean that's
an example of somebody who isn't capable of breaking out of their norm of eating.
All right, there's that, but like, I mean, that's a weird, I guess I'm not well equipped for this argument, but I'm like,
okay, somewhat, I'm just wondering, because
but no, I mean, that's incredible willpower to do that, to like go. But like that person's also like something has made them that way, that they're willing and able to do that.
Ooh, I don't like this. This is getting towards behavioral psychology, which is like one of my most detested fields.
Like, I mean, true willpower is like, do you like go skydiving today and like, or no, do you go like hang gliding today and like careen into a cliff, or like do you turn your fucking car in traffic, and just take like life by the balls? Like, there's a lot of things that we do because of social norms or because of our own conditioning that we don't break out of because of danger, first of all, but then also because of like the social norm of it. Like, we have such massive things piling on us that like I don't necessarily believe in free will. Thanks for the follow, well, man.
Much appreciated. I'm a part of this podcast too, but I can't see it because I'm on.
You gotta monitor from mod view, man.
Good point.
You're the other moderator.
I know. I'm big mod.
There is a macro and microcosm of thing. All things happen according to God's plan. Macrocosm, but on the microcosm sense, I choose to eat this hamburger instead of the wings. Right, but like, is it like those are your two options? But those are also two things that you like. So, is there really the like? You're not gonna go eat glass. Like, you're not gonna.
Yeah, but the ability to think about and then choose to do so, it has a lot to do with your. Okay, so you need the knowledge, right? You need to be conscious of the fact that you have free will and have the choices for any of us to happen, right?
God has better shit to do than ordain Dreamer to eat the burger. I'm so sorry.
God ordained you to eat the
do
burger.
Do it, boy! Eat that burger.
You've been told.
Oh man, he's not like curing cancer, Dreamer, it's okay to eat that burger.
Pint glass, actually, after I electrocuted myself.
Oh man, you got some willpower there. You got willpower.
So that's why it has to do with, like, okay, if we want to be really pedantic here.
Oh, yes, we do. We must.
Which is, but the thing about being pedantic is, like, I think that's usually where people go with the anti-free will argument, is that they generally get into that cyclical idea of, like, well, if you do this, it's a result of this thing that made you do this. So even if you made the choice, it's because this thing and this thing and this thing. But if you go down that sort of slippery slope,
logic.
It's not beneficial because you don't actually think about
things. Give a shit about that benefit. Lead to that point. We don't give a shit about the benefit here. It's what is scientifically true and not true.
Well, I would say that we have free will then scientifically.
Okay, so fuck. I'm not equipped to argue this. Because I'm not going to convince you because I just like. Oh, that sounds.
I mean,
that sounds right. That's about as far as I've gotten into it. Yeah, that sounds about right. There's a whole layer of conditioning and a layer of like social engineering that's not even like not something.
Well,
we
here,
see.
Here, there's I believe I gotta find it. I think it's a work by Lord Byron, actually.
Oh, dope.
which to me is one of the greatest.
Was this between fucking his sister and stealing the vampire, or was this before fucking his sister?
Oh, this is something he actually did himself.
Hydrate. Like, I have willpower, and I'm going to. Oh, there's a cooldown on that. I have willpower. See, I'm going to. Tristan, I can't refund those points from here, but you can. So.
What happened? I was trying to look up this.
Who is
this.
Who? I'm Ted Daniels. I'm Elliot.
Did you not hydrate three times?
Nope, I'm not going to because I have free will.
There, then you can do that.
Mm-hmm.
But
I'm also playing devil's advocate all the time. So.
Oh, I know you are.
Channel. So.
I'm
refusing this hydrate. Shut up, me.
Well, if you say you refuse, that's totally fine. Like, the only result of free will and exerting your independence is accepting consequences.
I can't get to there's mod view. Okay, so Squidbill's back. I've literally been raised in a church by an ordained minister, but my dad still tells me to go to a doctor when I'm sick. My life and religion views are touch skewed. Yeah, I mean, like, I've heard of scientists that, like, go home, like, and they're devout Christians at the end of the day, but then, like, it's compartmentalization. It's a weird... that's certainly a question I found myself pondering a lot in my youth. Like, does God care which brand of cereal I eat for... No, he does not. I mean, if he existed, I doubt he would care. Ted, are you free will or no? I'm leaning towards Elliot, by the way. And it was Tad in that bit. I'm anti-free will just because I've not been, like, proven otherwise, I guess. Sorry, but I'm not so active. That's fine, Squidville.
Oh, that's fine. That's
totally
fine.
You doing stuff. I was still TikToking. You just plug in that TikTok, dude. I'm never going to get TikTok. I'm so sorry. A touch skewed, does that mean you left the church? I've never done been in the church myself, personally, because my parents loved me.
Mm-hmm.
They still do. And they still do. Let the boy choose. Man, my mom's Catholic, and she's like, I'm not going to do that to him. He can choose.
Well, I honestly grew up, I grew up choosing my own path as well.
So my parents didn't love you? I mean, they thought they did what's best for you, but...
Yeah.
Also, like, at some point, somebody who, like, divined this power structure didn't care. The whoever's like, man, this person's really big. If I tell them that my invisible sky friend is gonna kick his ass, I could probably conquer him and take his sheep. So
take his sheep, because that's the first thing we would do then.
I mean, that's actually, like, what do you do when you're all like agricultural ass? Like, just let's refund these, reject. Have your points back. Okay, but in any event, I agree that God likely doesn't care what cereal I eat, and he probably does care how I treat my friends. So where exactly is the line?
I honestly think that we've had a similar conversation once at Squidville about...
I'm not going to argue the premise, I guess, of like where does the Yah and Way... becoming Yahweh, where does this fucking sheep herder god become? I mean, if you think that everything's predestined, then like you were gonna choose Captain Crunch because it's the better cereal. There's a lot of like lines of logic going on here. Fire Resistance Podcast. No, in my heart of hearts, I believe God is the answer to all things. However, I'm not going to overlook the millions of years of hundreds of thousands of years of medical science. By my vision is bad. I need glasses. The Lord provided me a job and has good optic benefits and let me go to the optometrist. Yeah, he also gave you shitty eyes, dude.
Well, I'm going to sit here and be like, I'm just happy that Dreamers and Fire are here talking with us, despite... Potentially, it sounds like having...
At what point is talking to God mental illness? That's what I want to know.
Well, some would say that...
if you actually hear the voices and think it's like a religion, like how many like schizophrenic pastors do you think there were?
I forgot her name. I only know her name in French now.
Oh, there was one?
Remember, Jean-Tac. Shit. Is it Joan of the Arc?
Oh yeah,
I only know her name in French now at this point, because I read all the history.
Charlemagne. You don't know Charles the Great, you know Charlemagne.
Yeah, Joan of Arc. Okay, Jeanne d'Arc, same thing. But like, that's an example of where maybe we were dealing with a mental ailment in which we did not have the knowledge to deal with the situation, right?
I like that fire and brimstone dude from, is it Hawthorne? That, like, the black-veiled preacher, that dude was metal. He's like, y'all are burning in hellfire, because these fucking witches... He wouldn't have had, like, a southern, he'd been, like, more Boston. Oh my god, park the car. Y'all are... I can't do a Boston very well. Can you do a Bill Burr doing the black-veiled preacher? telling you you're gonna burn in hell because you didn't park the car.
You're gonna burn in hell!
Oh.
God damn it!
Joel Osteen. Joel Osteen. No, that's not mental illness, that's greed.
Ted, you should look.
I mean, maybe he does have mental illness, but that's just straight up greed. I mean, that's like, Joel Osteen is just playing the religion. He's playing the part so well.
It makes sense, Elliot.
When you have a whole bunch of Bill. But when you have like a whole bunch of Romans who like you need to subjugate, and telling them to turn the other cheek is the best way to do it. Like, man, if someone slaps you, you turn the other cheek and you let him slap the other cheek. When you say eye for an eye leaves the world blind. How do you, like, civilize these people so you can control them under one banner instead of having, like, a series of gods? It's a very simple It's a very simple control tactic. And, like, having it written into your bylaws is real smart. So what was the Elliot, by the way. You should look up Dr. Gene Scott. I probably won't. When he preached, he smoked and drank. Okay, that's awesome. You know that,
I love how you're just like, I probably won't. But
no, I mean, I probably won't. So, who's the comedian? He was a Baptist minister, or he was going to be one. Kinison. Sam Kinison was like the son of a preacher until like a fucking truck hit him and his brain changed. Like, same thing happened to Roseanne, a fucking car accident, and your brain changes and then you become like more aggressive and more like. So he was either going to be like a Baptist minister or a comedian. Yeah. And like, he was railing coke, so he just used that, like, he just used that Jesus energy to like
Jesus energy
just to talk to people
he
on
was
stage.
On the Jesus hype train this
Pentecostal
whole time.
Preacher, thank you. Pentecostal, isn't that the isn't that the fucking snake charmers?
Is that the bad one?
Isn't that the snake charmers? If this snake bites me, then God thinks I'm a dildo.
Oh wow. Well, wouldn't have God already thought
See,
you
this
were
is
a
why
dildo?
This is why I didn't want to talk. Like, let's talk politics and religion this time, or science and religion, because I will rail against you so hard.
I'm literally
tongues
here.
Jumping and crazy stuff. Yeah, but like you're gonna say it's crazy stuff too. But that's just how they talk to God, dude. Like, they're not wrong.
I'm still here. Like, what the fuck did you say about free will?
I know, right? I want to get back to
I'm
that.
Just like, I'm
we,
like,
we're going from something you know to something that I. It you says, know, you I mean, know. The Bible also says don't let women vote and don't have mixed fabrics. The Bible says a lot of dumb shit because it was written by sheep herders.
I don't know much about the history of the Bible. I just know
because you were raised pagan, so
yeah, exactly. I was raised pagan, so I didn't have much exposure. Those are Levitical Jews meant for the Jew. Okay.
They're meant for the Jews, but like, then you're gonna read it now, and it's like, okay, every word of the Bible is God's honest truth, or it's up for interpretation. And if it's up for interpretation, then I can interpret it several ways.
I guess one of the major concerns I have was the conception of an Old and a New Testament, which I thought would be based on, of course, like. How Christianity works in terms of like the word of God or whatnot, I think would be problematic to have a new written version after
not at all.
The previous word.
Not at all.
No, I'm just saying. I mean, doesn't that seem like
that's how
that would be counterintuitive?
Every God was written over by the new. So, I mean, you start out with the pre-Titans, the gods before the Titans, right? But then there's there's slightly more and more understanding of science, so the gods change or events happen, right? So you have Gaia, you have her getting fucked by Uranus the sky god, and then you get Chrono. Then the Titans lead to the Greek pantheon. It's a simple logical like step forward, whereas like more and more. Time goes on and stories change and shift to like eventually you have like thousands of like Hindu gods. You have a whole pantheon.
The bigger
there.
The idea, the bigger the god.
It's so easy to like, well, this is an Abrahamic thing, right? So like the Abrahamic thing was to like unite all these fucking sheep herders under one banner so you could easily either control or govern, right? Like you literally have like, hey man, pork's bad for you because you'll get trichinosis and die. And then like these people are going to do it. So like, well, God said don't do it or else, so like now that's a safety thing, right? We don't mix fabrics because of some ridiculous reason. We don't do this because of some other ridiculous reason. Those reasons slowly go away, and then you can't explain that away anymore, so you change your religion. You change your banner, right?
Oh,
so
yeah. Well,
with the New Testament, Old Testament thing, you have the New Testament, which is like, how do we change all the Jews' minds to think this way? We convince them to all turn the other cheek, be meek and mild. We introduce a no prophet. Like, Islam did the same exact thing with the Quran. That's like the new Testament. That's like basically the third of the Abrahamic religions, right? Yeah. And all that did was like that. All that was written over 40 years of just like touring Arabia. I read up on how the Quran was written, and it was finally all put together after Muhammad died by all of his homies. They'd all just, like, he couldn't write himself, so he had, like, people who would, like, write down his stories as he, like, went. So this dude was just straight up, like, on a fucking, like, crusade. They put all the stories together. They're mostly plagiarized from the New Testament and the Old Testament. All of the angels are the same, all the characters are the same. They even said, like, hey, Jesus is real too. But that was in an attempt to unite all of these Arabian tribes, right? They were under a polytheism. Like, it was all tiny herding villages with their own religions. How do you unite them under your thumb for one thing? Well, you tell them all that all their gods are wrong, and then that yours is real and yours is powerful and yours is going to damn them or punish them however you see fit. And now you just, I mean, it's
there's other ways too, right?
It's basic control. It's not more than that.
One of my favorite ways that it happened was when you go in and you convince the person with the most power, and then you actually make the kings and the aristocracy
burn
all of the records, right, that they had of their previous lives, and then just switch over to the new religion, right?
There's this cool thing where, like, was it the Egyptians sacking Babylon? The original homeland of the Jews. So when you take, like, they sacked a city-state and they took all their religious iconography and they took it back to, I think it was either Egypt or Iran. And they're like, fuck Babylon, we got all you statues, we have the power of your god now. They literally thought that having this statue and this iconography and this city-state gave it its power. And if you stole my statues, then you now have my power. Until, like, some other pharaoh came up and he's like, man, we should probably, like, give Babylon all of their shit back. If that dude didn't, like, give Babylon all of their religious texts and iconography back, you don't have Judaism and you don't have Christianity. And you're going to tell me that, like, oh, man, history's wrong. The Bible.
Yeah. See, I'm not super well versed in this topic, so I'm mostly listening and trying to gather information.
You can't control them if they don't have free will. .. I mean, it's very easy to control the masses through, like, they're uneducated, so all you do is, like, some parlor trick or some, like, hey, I have swords, I have fire, I have men who I pay.
Like, which, by the way, I would say is, like, one thing that we mistake about the idea of free will is that if you do not have the knowledge of a certain situation due to lack of exposure, education, and really it just being a part of your world, like, how can you expect somebody to act against it in a way that, you know, we perceive you should have acted against it, right? Like, for example, I'm kind of particularly talking about Irish aristocracy. Like, we don't have much on Celtic stuff anymore because a lot of it was burned and destroyed and lost as a result of conversion.
Right. I mean, when you kick all the snakes out of Ireland.
Yeah, the druids.
Yeah, when you kick all the druids out of Ireland, it's a simple, like, why does the fucking line go from the Who? Meet the new boss, same as the old boss.
Yeah, same as the old boss.
Whoever had their banners, whoever had
and
their...
And I sent you the link.
Like, why do you think the Holy Roman Empire ruled all of Europe long after the fall of the Holy Roman Empire? because like all of like they conquered all of Europe, they put their religion and their governance in place. So even after it falls, like that's still how your country's built.
It took
fucking King Henry to be like, I want to fuck a different bitch because she ain't giving me sons, to say like, hey, we're not gonna listen to the Pope anymore. Like, where the Pope was like, yeah, dude, I kind of rule Europe, so you're gonna listen to me, and I'm ordained by God to rule Europe. So, like, you have the Protestants. You have the Protestant Revolution. Like, it's just like, yeah, dude, I don't have a son, so the English Empire is a little bit stronger. Our imperialism is better than your imperialism.
We're
gonna have India fight you, so fuck off. Like... It's such a weird... It's all about control. It's all about the gathering of resources. It's all about, like... a lot of slavery.
Oh, yeah.
Getting people to think your way. Mm-hmm. Crushing smaller cultures.
In my field, just think about the use of Latin as a controlling mechanism by the church.
Okay.
Use something that they can't read, right?
Right.
Like,
I mean...
Masses can't read this, so...
Lutheranism was awesome, because when Martin Luther translated the Bible... He accidentally created the Anabaptists, who are like, well, we didn't choose to be baptized, right? We read all this nonsense about this hippie Jesus dude being a socialist. And we don't like how like the power structure is going. We don't like all these oligarchs. We don't like all these aristocrats, the aristocracy. We don't like how the king is the wealthiest, right? It's like, didn't Jesus say that like it's easier for it's easier for a camel to pass through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to pass into heaven? And it's like,
I've heard that before. Then
look at all these haves and have-nots, right? And they literally spawned the first, like, communist ideas in 1500 Germany in Munster. I've talked about this before on the show, where the Anabaptists were basically, like, fucking raided by the king, and, like, their leaders were hung from the fucking church after they were flayed. Because, like, yo, no, dude, you can't have other religious ideas than us. That's not a very like loving, accepting. That's all power.
This is heavy. There's a lot here, Elliot.
I'm railing on the basic fact. Like, I'm sorry if I'm just going over it too much, but
no. I'm still thinking. In the back of my mind, I'm churning on free will. Like, you've really sparked something.
I'd like to. Could you want to get back to?
Oh, we don't have to get back to it, like, because this whole
convince me there's free will, I guess. Like, how would you go about convincing someone?
Listen. That there's free will?
There is free will.
I guess the easiest... Oh, okay, I can't say it's the easiest, because I wouldn't say that free will is necessarily easy, but I think that the answer lies in something that's very simple, which is actually what you want from a scientific explanation, right? You want the simplest, right? Oh, so now for the hardest question of all, JJ Watt.
Talking sports will get you banned faster than talking religion. I mean, I feel like we probably just, alienated half of the audience, but I mean, that's how I feel.
That's the thing. We have our platform, and we speak how we want, and other people have their platform, they speak how they want, right?
Yeah.
And I'm just glad that we have people here, you know, that have different beliefs, and we're talking about it regardless of how strong our beliefs may be.
Yeah, but I mean, here's the thing, dude. I'm not gonna march my army to your city and tell you to change your religious texts. I guarantee you, Worst Enemies Podcast will not skin you alive until you believe in our God. I can make that guarantee.
Yeah. Maybe a touch of levity and anybody could do. Yeah. We're having time with people. Yeah, that's how we do it, right? I think that's.
See chat like going quiet while I'm ranting. So just like.
Well, I think we got to get to the pause to say the.
Got you. And I'm jumping all over the place.
Yeah. Exactly. And that's why I was quiet too, because like I said, not a topic.
I'm gonna put my soapbox aside.
Okay, so I sent you the link to Manfred, which was a
Drop it in chat, because
okay, it was a play by Lord Byron.
Why did I not get? Did you drop it in Discord? Because
I think it was a play.
I'm not getting a notification.
It's a dramatic poem which has a play-like element to it. But
I just love the name Manfred.
Oh, yeah.
Venfred von Richthofen.
Imagine somebody doing something terrible and then having the power to summon a bunch of, like, supposedly powerful beings
Ooh.
To do a certain task, and then them all saying,
hey, fucking Mickey and the Broom.
Mickey and the Broom, yeah. And then summoning these powerful beings to do something, but they're only willing to do it
Dope.
Under certain, okay. Like, they need to get something for themselves as a result of it, right? And this one man's like, hey, if you said you can do it, why don't you just do it?
Want me to read the plot real quick?
Yeah, there you go. That works.
Manfred is a Faustian noble living in the Bernese Alps. Okay, so Bernese Alps. So it's north of Italy. What side? Bernese. Whatever. I could just... Bernese Alps. Okay, the French. German, Berner, Alpen, French.
Yeah.
So it's literally the German-French... Okay, that's right between. Cool. Initially tortured by some mysterious guilt, which has to do with the death of his most beloved Esther, he uses his mastery of language and spellcasting to summon seven spirits, from whom he seeks forgetfulness. Whoa. The spirits who rule the various components of the corporeal world are unable to control past events and thus cannot grant Manfred's plea. For some time, fate prevents him from escaping his guilt through suicide. Oh, I think I vaguely know. Like, he tried, like, a bunch of elaborate ways to kill himself, but, like, at the end, Manfred dies, defying religious temptations of redemption from sin. Throughout the poem, he succeeds in challenging all of the authoritative powers he faces and chooses death over submitting to the powerful spirits. Manfred directs the final word to the abbot, remarking, "Old man, 'tis not so difficult to die." This sounds like a dope, like, diehard.
Yeah,
like,
Manfred is a badass. Unconquerable individual to the end. Manfred gives his soul to neither heaven nor hell, only to death. The ultimate example of free will. He stands before every single supposedly ultimate powerful, like, you know, greater power, asks them for something. They're incapable of doing it by just doing it. In the poem, he basically says to all of them, like, hey, can you do it? And they're like, hey, we want this in return. And he's like, no, if you can do it, just do it. And they're like, no, we want something. He's like, well, then fuck off. And he goes to the next one. And they all try to get something from him as a result. Tells them all to fuck off, and then he just commits suicide instead of seeking this redemption through other means. Like, he just wants to forget. And at the end of the day, he's the ultimate free will individual. He doesn't give in to all these
religion.
Yeah.
Okay, so I mean, that's a cool poem. Critique. In June 1817, Manfred has the epigraph, the famous phrase, Shakespeare's Hamlet. There's more than heaven and death, Horatio. Okay, what is an actual, real?
Accused Byron of egotism, contradiction, and affection. He was made for crime, not vice.
Okay, I mean, well, yeah, Byron was, like, a straight-up narcissist, egoist, like...
Oh, yeah, he was straight-up.
Even I have, like, free will, like... Of course I have free will. I fucked my own sister. Oh, man. That's Byron. I mean, he literally had to, like, escape to Switzerland.
The reason is in the poem is that he asserts that if they were capable of doing it, they should be able to show him that they can do it. And by them like not doing it for without a price, he tells them basically, then screw you. I have no time for you then. He's basically saying that if they can't display it to him.
Oh, so what were they asking, I think, is the question. I guess the question is why would Manfred not be willing to give something to the spirits to gain his desires? So that would depend on what they're asking. So
yeah.
Can we get that? Characters, scenes. Okay, scene one, Manfred alone scene, gothic galley, time, midnight. Dope. I already love it. Scene two, the mountain of Jungfrau, time, morning, Manfred alone atop the cliffs. Act two. Scene one, a cottage amongst the Bernese Alps. Manfred and, okay, is it hard CH or is it soft CH? Chamois Hunter. Scene two, a lower valley of the Alps.
Chamois.
Chamois, okay. Chamois. French.
Yeah.
These are just the scenes. Surrounded by spirits, okay. Hall of the Castle of Manfred. Yeah, but what do they actually ask of him? What are the spirit are we like
clip of your show? Yeah.
Oh god. Yep. I fuck my sister. That's what's gonna be.
Well, so the okay, so then why he would have gotten his reward without paying for it. That's the point, is that
I realized as I was saying it. Of course I have free will, I fucked my own sister.
Is this out of there context? We go. Yeah. Yep. That's the second time.
Of course I have free will. I didn't say it. I was gonna say clip it, and then I caught myself not saying clip it. I'm like, maybe they'll forget. Nope. So very Christ-like.
So the reason that it's like the ultimate or one of the ultimate examples of human rugged individualism, that's actually a totally different, actually kind of unfortunate concept of free will, is because even though he could get what he wanted easily, he continued to say, if you can't do it this way, my way, the way I've chosen, then I don't believe you in your way that you're capable of it. He basically was telling them all they don't have the power that they say they have because they're not doing it his way, which seems kind of really rude and terrible, right? But remember, it was written by Byron.
Right.
Who was a rugged. I keep almost using that.
He's not rugged, though. He's very foppish.
Yeah, exactly. Which it sounds absurd because it is. To anybody, it seems like, oh, well, if he just gave up the one thing or gave away the one thing, then he could just get what he wanted, which seems very human, right? Just to accept some of the consequences.
Here's an actual, like, more... he seeks oblivion. Is this because he fucked his sister that he wrote this? Because, like, hey, man, I want to undo that. Is that what made Lord Byron write this?
I am not aware of...
him fucking his sister.
Yeah.
Okay, well, maybe you should look into that, because it's pretty fucking risque, dude. Wow, that's...
Oh, it looks like... Yeah, he did, because Manfred was written immediately after this, and because it regards the main character tortured by his own sense of guilt, some consider it to be autobiographical, or even conventional, I could see.
It's the whole reason he, like, fled the country to, like, avoid press and paparazzi, and that, like fucking... Frankenstein don't get written without this dude fucking is... I'll stop saying it.
Wow, is this a barbershop? Because we got another great clip.
Yep. Thanks, Nathan. That's awesome. But yeah, Frankenstein, Mary Shelley wrote or started, like, the bet was started to write the scariest story, and that's when she's like, finally I'm going to put all this stuff together as Frankenstein.
Yeah.
And then, like, he stole the vampire from the other, from his doctor, and published it as himself.
Yeah, Byron wasn't, like, wasn't...
He's a shitty dude.
Yeah, he was also kind of a rock star in his time.
Oh, yeah. 27 Club, baby. So he asked spirits to take forms. Spirits that control earth, sky, water, mountain. Mm-hmm. Earth and mountain, those are different. Wind, night, and destiny. Can bring the oblivion he seeks. The spirits reply, however, they have no power beyond their own realms. When Manfred, failing in his hopes, asks the spirits to take bodily forms, the seventh spirit, the star of his destiny, takes the shape of a beautiful woman. After the sight of her, Manfred, hinting at a former love, attempts to hold her, but she vanishes, leaving him senseless. An unidentified voice then utters a lengthy incantation in which Manfred is cursed and seemingly condemned to wander the earth forever with his spiritual agony unassuaged. I mean, I'm still not convinced that free will's a thing, but it's a cool story.
Yeah. Well, cool story, bro, but still.
The next morning alone on a cliff in Jungfrau in the Bernese Alps, Manfred resolves to forego all superhuman aid. He praises the beauty... of nature around him, but also... So yeah, he's after a bender. He wakes up in the woods.
So he gets really hungover after Byron, he finds out that all these spirits can't do shit.
Byron would do. These fucking spirits. I mean, that's kind of like a huge thing that we're just going to leave out there, right? I summoned all these goddamn spirits.
Oh, wait. He has magical powers? Did we forget this? Like,
here's the problem, boys. Like, I'm fine with those clips being there because, haha, they're funny. I said funny things and you clipped me. You got me out of context. But, like, then Connell is going to shout me out on his thing and that plays random clips. And that brings...
Oh, God.
Yeah. God damn it. I'm just going to stop saying funny things then. Y'all can go fuck yourselves.
They just clipped that. I'm going to stop saying funny things. No. But, that's not a...
Delete the clip. I could, but then it's not fun.
Yeah, because...
I don't have free will. I can't delete that clip. Twitch...
I mean, if you then choose if what you want to do...
If I delete the clip, I'm a poor sport.
Is there an example of something that would let you believe in free will? In a free will?
Is there an example of something? I mean, like, you would have to break out of social norm. Like, I mean, even if you killed yourself, it's just like you're trying that hard to prove that there's free will. Like, so that's part of your personality. Like, that's part of your... Like, I'm so standoffish and I'm so, like, willing to prove that this is a thing that I'll, like, end my entire existence to prove you wrong. Like, that just seems like a weird... And, like, this isn't even my hill to die on. I just, like, I guess I just lean towards...
I would say that not accepting free will to that extent, like I said, it's not you. I'm saying that the concept of not accepting free will generally results in cyclical pedantic arguments.
You're 100% right. We're just going in circles now. Well, I mean, like, this is not my hell to die with. Free will's bullshit. Like, what, define free will? Like, I can, let's define it, I guess.
Okay, well, I guess that's difficult because free will, like, is very dependent on the individual, I suppose. But if we were going to go for a universal concept of free will, it would be basically the ability to assert oneself and to change one's decisions based on what it is they want to do, right?
The power of acting without the constraint or necessity of fate. The ability to act as one's own discretion. So, I mean, right there, I disagree with the first... The power of acting without the constraint of necessity or fate. I mean, so like, well, let's define fate. Because, I mean, I think fate's a weird subject as well. Like, I mean, there's inevitability, but that's not exactly fate. It's like, you set this house of cards a tumbling, like, eventually, like, that's, you know what I mean? Like, these series of events led up to this thing. Of course, this thing was going to happen. Is that fate or is that just coincidence?
So even I'd say my favorite philosopher doesn't necessarily believe in free will. Albert Camus, or Albert Camus to some people.
Act at one's own discretion.
You know, the whole myth of Sisyphus, right? Where Sisyphus, like, you know, has basically pissed off the gods, and now he has to roll the stone up the hill infinitely, right?
Oh, I thought that was... Oh, okay, that's Sisyphus. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, okay. So, I get my Titans confused.
So Camus states that basically the fact that he chooses to continue to roll up the stone up the hill stoically is him defying the gods. They don't get to see him depressed, defeated. The gods don't get to win because he continues to roll the stone, right? And that's kind of asserting yourself against the absurdity of life, which you apparently have no control over, by continuing to do the thing, right? That somebody has told you,
you need to do. Man, I think there's a massive problem here where people are personifying things.
What do you mean?
The biggest issue is that the argument is would first have to know what fate's plan is for us. So why does fate have a plan? Why is there, like, okay, if there's, we personify everything. It's so weird. If there is a God, if there is a higher power, it is not that of the Bible. If there's a universe creating entity out there, it is so much more like incredible and amazing than anything.
It's Kathy Lou.
It's Kathy Lou, right? But if there's an actual force out there that created this, that isn't just like explained by science. If there is a what's the word? Not a creator, but like whoever flipped the white light switch. What's the enacting of the first force, like the first pusher or whatever, first cause, close. But if there's that, then it's like, it's so doesn't give a shit about what you or I do. Like, it's this multi-dimensional thing that, like, has no explanation that we know of that exists, that would exist on such a higher plane. Like, there's an infinite universe out there, like, right? And it's like, at this point, it's not a god, it's a force of nature. You know what I mean? And like, then to personify a force of nature, like, man, what's gravity's plan for me? I guess I'm gonna fall. Like,
wow.
Catalyst is close. A supreme being, but like, there's a term for it. Like, the first cause is so close. It's,
to add to that,
the prime mover. I think it's the prime mover.
Yeah, okay, I see what you mean. Oh, is it the, what's his name? There's another philosopher who said that there's a primary mover and the moved, and...
Gravity's always a downer.
Don't hang around it too much.
Amazon Prime. See, like, the chat's awesome. You can always put levity back into stuff. But, this is something that's bothered me for so long. It's just, like, if there is an actual god that, like, then it's like, well, are you an atheist now because there's an actual god? It's like, well, it literally doesn't matter what I am because this thing is so vastly beyond us that it literally does not give a shit. Like, something that sneezed in the fucking universe was then created. Or some sort of Akira incident where, like, some kid fucking turned into a black hole and now we're all here. Like... It is so insignificant, like, or some failed science experiment where they tried to create the fucking hadron, God particle, and they made a universe inside of a universe, or
boson. No,
some stupid, like, it's at that point, like, if it was an accident, doesn't matter. If it was like on purpose, why? And then do you actually care what kind of sugar cereal I grab?
Isn't that a part of the fact that if you're talking about behaviorism, fate, and all this stuff, which I do have some issues with, then you would find that human egoism is the element that's making us believe that this supreme being wants anything to do with us beyond the conception of us, right?
Right.
That we're somehow chosen.
Are you saying we were a pump and dump?
You say we were pump?
Yo, are we just a...
He laid the seed, and that should be all you need.
Yeah, like, that's, like, it all comes down to things that you can then explain. Like, egoism. Thank you for putting a term to it. Okay, what do we got here? The story so far, in the beginning of the universe was created, there was, made a lot of people very angry. I love Douglas Adams. It was a bad
very,
move.
Very, very witty. Very
he's my favorite author, hands down. I fucking love The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy series. With fucking dolphins take off. So long. Thanks for all the fish.
It's also the reason why I like Pratchett a lot, too.
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely absurd.
Yeah.
Death trying to save Christmas.
Oh.
Stuff like that. Honestly, this is something that actually has to do with free will.
Okay.
I am a firm believer that if, in fact, there is a supreme being that believes that it should assert sort of its power and its force against us, right? If in fact it is not preventing us from thinking about it and from acting against it, then it is 100% certain that we should fight against this being. If we have the ability to do so, right? If we have the ability to think for ourselves and act out against this supposed being, then we should do so 100%.
You know, those
free will.
Those just sounds like Lucifer's lies to me, dude. You're a fucking devil being. Was that pagan?
You pagan?
Didn't fucking St. Patrick get rid of you?
You want to hear a pagan story?
Well, why do we need to act against it then? Like, why does it matter? What is it? That's another egoism, like where now its intentions for us are bad, that it even has intentions for us.
No. It's bad. It's innately bad if it says that it can exert power over us, but clearly we have the ability to ignore that. Like then it's not omnipotent.
It's just like ghosts trying to tickle you. Like, hey, stop.
Because well, that's like, the thing. Why would you say that you have this sort of power? And the ability to prevent us
from doing stuff.
You don't.
Oh, then you got to take the fucking. You got to every God's plan. He's testing us. Why? Why is my test so much easier than others? What did I do?
Why am I the chosen?
No. Right, like, why do I get to wear the Nikes, but this kid's got to make them for me?
Was egotistical.
Why is that?
Abraham.
Why is there juvenile cancer? Abraham? Yeah, what a dick. I mean, anyway. you know, like, I like this argument. It's fun. If you take the statistical, like, how many people do you think lived on Earth in the time of man? Right? In, like, the 100,000 or, like, even, like, 20,000 years, let's say. In the time of man, how many people lived? Can you just guess? Because there's a number.
There's a number?
There's an estimation.
It was much, much, much smaller than it is now.
That's okay. No.
No. Okay. I mean, what? Okay. Let me know because I don't know.
Statistically, there's 100 billion humans that have walked the face of the Earth. Right? They've come and gone since the time.
Oh, okay. I see. All
right. So 100 billion people. Right? You want to know the infant mortality rate of history?
50%.
50%.
Okay.
50 billion dead babies in a fucking lake of fire, boys. 50 billion dead unbaptized babies that were unsaved
souls.
That is
if you're Irish Catholic.
Right.
But,
so there's like, I mean, like that alone is like a shuddering number to like this is a just, loving creature. This is someone to be feared. Like if I was to be like religious, it's like, man, this dude fucking hates us. How do we get on his good side? Like, I don't know. My mom, weird.
No,
there are a lot of religions where like, I mean, the Baptists say that babies go to hell. Like they're unbaptized. Lots of Catholics, baby. That, like,
I'm just
thinking or they go to purgatory. That. And like, oh, what is hell? But like the absence of God's love. And that's the other thing too, is like the invention of hell is another fun thing. It used to just be like, well, you don't go to heaven, which is mansion land, mansion cloud land. That's all that, like, the Bible says, is that it's a nice neighborhood. We got ADT everywhere.
It's a gated community.
Yeah, we got one of those. He's the guard, but, like, he's one of the good ones.
I'm just making a joke about the harsh nature of Irish Catholicism.
My mom's.
If you want to read some really good examples of it, read James Joyce's books.
Bro, my mom is straight up Irish Catholic, so like she spared me that. She's like,
Oh yeah.
No more Irish, no Irish Catholicism for my kids, dude. If they can think what they want. Anyway, because it's always the Catholics that they're so repressed that they're always the worst people. Like they always act out the most. Anyway, so purgatory no longer exists. That's the whole thing. So before it was purgatory, right? You go to purgatory. That's not enough, right? There's still people sinning. There's people not believing in us, right? Okay, so now we're gonna go to hell, right? Well, hell, your soul is going to be purified, right? And then you'll return to God once all the sins burned out, right? Well, that's still not scary enough for these fucking sheep herders, right? So now it's you burn in an eternal damnation in a lake of hellfire. And it's not even the bad part. The bad part is you're away from God's love. Now, that just sounds like an abusive boyfriend, doesn't it?
Yeah, I'd have to say so. Given the way that you've explained it there.
I mean, but that's like, there was no hell, and then it's like, well, why is there hell? Well, it's to scare people into acting the way you want them to. It's back to the power struggle.
Because free will and religion are weaving in and out in this conversation.
That's where the whole idea of like free will is like when you tell me free will, like I hear the religious use, like, well, then God gave us free will and we have to choose to love him. It's like, well, that's just more steps. That's like, why can't we just, like, live now and be good to each other? Because it's the right thing to do. Like, why do we need someone, like, watching over us to say, hey, like, you don't touch that. Don't do that. If you do that, you're going to burn forever. It's like, how about just, like, I don't know if there's an afterlife or not. I can't scientifically prove it one way or the other. So, like, I'm just assuming this is my one ticket, right? This is it. This is all I have. So, like, why would I want to spend this time being a dick to somebody when, like, we could all have a good time, right?
Oh, yeah. Well, and that's why, like, I'm quite the proponent of absurdism, where, like, it's about living in the present, because living in the future is basically fabricating a reality that you don't have any evidence of possibly happening. And living in the past is living in something that has already happened, and you're perpetuating into a present that wasn't actually.
Babies don't go to hell, then why do we baptize? Where do babies go when they die?
Doesn't that just depend on the...
Exactly. Just what version of this... What one of the 60 versions, the 60 plus versions of this version of Judeo-Christianity, like, where does that take you? Where do babies go right after birth when they die? Because it's just so many... Like, there's Catholics. What do they think?
I thought that had a lot to do with which denomination you are, because the beliefs seem to change quite a bit, sometimes not a lot.
That's not the preaching that I've heard. Like, you literally, like, we consecrate this baby so that if they die, the fucking devil can't get them. So now you're just like picking and choosing.
Well, that's why I'm like saying, like, I'm a pagan, and I didn't go really deep into Christianity, but I've only heard so much information throughout life.
You lucked out, dude. Hey, does your life feel any emptier without the presence of a higher power?
Not really, because, like, at least in my belief system, like, you don't have to worship any of the deities. Well, actually, there's one in particular, but I feel like...
Is he a Chad?
Well, I was going to say it's not a man to begin with, but...
So it's like Irish paganism, because the paganism is such a broad term.
It's Celtic paganism. But I mean, I don't generally go deeply into it, because it's not really a part of my spiritual belief to really.
Oh, okay. So there's nothing. Well, the Catholic Church has defined doctrine on original sin, it has none on the eternal fate of unbaptized infants, leaving theologians free to propose different theories. So it's theoretical. So if there's not a fucking, like, then why do we do this?
Well, Dreamer says, what I was taught was that once we come of age of understanding good and evil, we choose to be baptized as a form of worship and obedience.
Right. That's more of the Anabaptist line of thinking.
Okay.
Where, like, you gotta be old enough to choose, and then you can get rebaptized, and then you can join the faith, because, like, their idea was, like, you have to give yourself to this thing, whereas the normal just Christianity thing is like, well, no, we got you from birth. This is it. We control you now. Give us 10% of your income, fight in our armies.
And I found that to be fairly true, Fire, that, like, there is a lot of...
I mean, Catholics are a weird marrying of Christianity and Roman paganism, right? So now you have Roman soldiers who are not allowed to kill because this god says they can't kill. So how do you convince Roman soldiers to go kill if they're going to go to hell? Because now they're newly Christian, they're newly the Roman, Holy Roman Empire, right? You tell them that these are heathens and non-believers, and they're pagans, and that you're killing them, and they're going to burn in hell. Or, like, you can convert them along the way, but they're sinners, right? So they're all going to go to hell. After Christianity hit Rome, the Germans invaded, right? And then, but the Germans were also Christians, so they left the temples alone, and if you went inside of a church, you're good, right? Well, So you're outside of this church, you're my enemy, right? You're a Roman, fuck you, I'm taking your land. But inside this building, God said I can't touch you. Isn't that a weird...
Well, yeah, that is weird. I kind of like the taxing Rome a little bit more. you know, where they're like, yeah, do your thing, but yeah, pay your tax. But although apparently if you were in like actual Rome, there was a little bit more of like, hey man, don't be spouting your stuff because this is Rome. But of course that would work that way, right?
Okay, still, getting off the side of baptism, the idea that there's 50 million dead babies, that's like, I guess life's just, or 50 billion, that's, life's just not as precious as they say, I guess?
I mean, like I said, I don't have enough knowledge.
I mean, it's just a law of numbers. How many fucking dead carpenter ants does it take to, like, make the colony? It's just a,
well, if we're going to talk about, I know about bugs.
Like life is just like uncaring. Like, don't personify these things.
There's no carpenter ants don't care as long as the colony works.
Right. I mean, so why are we different? Just because we can reason, we can make structures. We could make up nonsense that makes our lives weird and more challenging.
Just like Amazon.
Just like Amazon. Anyway, like, I'm just...
When do I get a package from our god?
What does fate have for me? Don't fucking personify shit. My Airbnb got denied because the owner said we smoked weed on their property. Yeah, the president of a 401c3 gonna smoke weed on your property.
So they just assumed you would do something.
Squatter's rights, bro.
Squatter's rights. We were here first.
Oh, that's literally a thing with Airbnbs, is they're having difficulty kicking certain people out in certain areas.
I mean, even if you were the president of like a nonprofit organization,
and
you
smoking
property, weed, I would be like, whatever, man.
Like, why, you're less likely to rail coke or like fuck hookers. Yeah. Like, what makes you so much more morally better than?
I just think that the person, the Airbnb person, is just ridiculous. But
yeah,
in general, I don't.
Hey, I told you what I do. Didn't you generalize me like how you're supposed to?
Do you look like a young person? You gonna do this?
It's a weird note to wrap up on, but we've been going for almost 3 hours now.
Yeah, it is profiling. Yeah, we're getting to the point where we actually gone over, but...
But you're 100% right. It's why, like, hey, let's talk about a religion and science. And I'm like, can we not? Because I knew,
can we not?
Cause I knew this was...
I think we had a good podcast as a result, and I'm really glad that
over is better.
Like, you're willing to talk about...
So there's legal profiling and there's illegal profiling, so... I liked it. Well, thanks for hanging out.
I appreciate it.
I'm just gonna feel weird all day now.
No, I mean, I think we all had a fairly mature conversation, right? And we discussed things.
Weird is good. Yeah, but weird, like, not weird like, hey man, I'm gonna move to Portland and shave my head and just drop acid. Like, I'm weird as in, like, I don't know.
Oh, do you wanna explain it?
I mean, I think it's your turn to explain it. Wait. Okay, so you want the origin or you want the meaning? Because, obviously, in this show, we try to, like, I believe that people tend to get in their own ways and be their own worst enemy. And I think we tend to get in the ways of others as well. So we can't really progress, like, historically speaking, exactly. Like, if we just got out of our own way, we'd be in a much better place right now. We'd have, like, we'd have like a Dyson sphere, probably. We'd be harnessing power from the sun and not from like lizard blood. Anyway, that's another tangent.
Yeah, yeah. The fuel energy. We could discuss that eventually here, but we tend
to get in our own ways, not just our own, but in the ways of others. And I think like when I thought of the name, it was because remember the forest fires where they were started by a gender reveal party where a smoke grenade caught a bush on fire, and there's footage of this, and the people are just like, oh shit, and they just kind of left it, and this started a massive like raging forest fire. I saw this little clip and I'm like, man, we really are our own worst enemies, and we're just gonna devour ourselves unless we as a society change and try to like better ourselves, better each other. What, who the fuck does that, man? Like, I need to know the fucking what's in your child's pants so bad. Since I supposedly smoke weed, need to good strain to find. Where are you at? I could hook you up.
Pick a fruit and pick a kush and move. No. Pick a kush and fine. Go and move down
no one
the
got
line.
No one got defensive. No one defended our points and belief. Okay, but not angrily. Yeah. I got up to here. So I wasn't up here. I wasn't angry, but I got real. Anyway, I try to make a nice chill environment for people.
And I think that's like what we do here.
Discussion. Those are always fun. Well, I'm glad everybody enjoyed it. I'm glad everybody hung out and stuck with us. Let's talk politics. Oh my god, dude. Here's why you're wrong.
Here's why you're wrong. We're just about to end it here, but I was gonna add that
Trump 2024. Oh god.
I'm hoping we're planning on doing a little bit of we can pick a figure or something like JK. Historically, and we can see how they got it.
He almost got my blood boiling, dude.
Who did?
Trump 2024, JK. You mad at
people just messing with you, Ted.
He's just kidding. I've been Ted Rathenberger. This has been my cohort, Kristen Fiddles.
My name is Bill Burr.
Kristen here. Fiddles.
Fiddles.
Okay, I'm Elliot. This is
Brad A.
Where can we find you, boy?
You can find me over at twitch.tv/RathAVMoril. I'm just gonna shout myself out here.
Do it, man.
I can't stand doing it sometimes, but I can do it.
I said my name was Tad something, and I don't remember. I was doing a bit. I don't really like my name, but yeah, my name's Elliot. And then I proceeded to correct you through the entire show. So
yeah, I know. Holy shit! I just self-promoted.
Yeah, I'm like, it's Elliot, but Ted. That's Tad.
Might as well burn my mother. She's a witch.
You've been getting my fake name wrong this whole time.
Shout out Drondia.
Hell yeah! Shout out Drondia. Shut up, Pokimane. She'll never know. Oh, man. Anyway, I should probably, eat something. It's fucking 5
o'clock.
Yeah,
I gotta head out.
This was great for having nothing to talk about. We went 46 minutes over. Oh, this is gonna take forever to upload.
Okay. Oh, and I think you can turn off certain things from the...
Give everybody this beautiful graphic. Shout out my mom! And let's end it and pick somebody to raid.
Monster Man.
How about anyone got a good raid in mind? I'm gonna later. Everybody, be excellent to each other. Okay, can you do that for me?
Yeah.
And done.